WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
Love, Yoko. Enough, please, no more. Good morning. Wow, did Davey? Happy birthday, Davey!
Oh, happy birthday, bud.
Today's you're how old today? Hold on, he's got to finish his breakfast. And you are how old today?
I'm 48 today.
Wow! You don't look a day over 30.
Thank you.
Yeah.
But sometimes I feel over 50.
Yeah, trust me, I get it. It was the perfect storm last night.
Yeah.
And there we go once again with the zone defense. And I really felt like Colgate in the first half played so well with, I mean, they weren't hitting the three pointers, but man, they were getting inside, and which should have opened up the 3-point ball. But the problem is Texas was hitting the 3-pointers against the zone defense.
They had 15 of them, 15 3-pointers.
It was a team that Colgate just could not beat.
Right.
And Jeff, are we looking at the end of the zone defense in college basketball?
Look, it's possible because, again, when a guy gets hot, you can't do anything. Colgate was up 12-9 in that game, turned the ball over, bad turnover. On the break, they get a foul and the bucket. So it becomes 12-9 becomes, a 10-9 lead becomes a 12-10 deficit. And then that kid Reed or Rice hit four threes in a row. It was ridiculous.
It was
you
ridiculous.
You can't defend that. And you certainly, if you're not even going to put a hand in his face, you can't defend it.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the game. That was the game. They just could not defend against Texas. Wow.
And I felt like there was never, after that run, there were a couple of minutes that went by, and then they rattled off a 17-1 run. The fact that they were down 9 at the half, I thought, was an accomplishment.
Yes.
It was, wow. You know, and we talked to somebody earlier. Maybe it was Coach Langle who said, look, you know, this team gets hot. They just go on a streak, and they go on a streak from downtown, and you got to watch out for that, and hopefully that doesn't happen, and boy.
Other part was that Coach Langle said they had to be firing on all cylinders, and that meant Colgate had to be hitting three-pointers, and they weren't answering, and wow, the season comes to a close.
And Colgate was number one in the nation in three-pointers, too.
I know. And, you know,
52%, I think.
They got a bad seed. If they could have been like a 14 or even they should have been like a 13 or a 12, you know, things might have been different. And then yesterday was certainly a day for upsets.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
You know, when a 15 upsets a 2, it's so rare. And that, to be honest with you, I thought Colgate had that working against them as well. You know, when you heard a 15 upset a 2, you hoped it was Colgate. But if it happened before the Colgate game, you knew that Texas was like, brace for this.
Yeah.
You're going to have to eat. You don't want this to happen to you. Yeah, so.
And Princeton, of all teams out there, right?
And Arizona. Some people had them, you know, winning the national championship.
Yeah.
But the biggest shocker from day one was Furman beating Virginia.
That was something, huh?
Virginia was been a number 3 seed over before. And this is the second time that they've been bounced out as a number 3 seed. And number 3 seed, and the kid that turned over the ball in the final seconds was a key member of their 2019
national
championship team.
Yeah, I think it was a 13-4 matchup, but maybe I'm wrong. Yeah.
All right, so a couple things to look forward to, and we got to make sure we get Heenan in and try to grab him, see if he'll come on at like 7:30 or something. I want to get him one last time before the weekend. There are tickets still available for tomorrow night's Utica University hockey game. It's they're dancing. It's the quarterfinals of the men's national championship. And if Utica wins tomorrow, believe me, they have some answering to do from last year. This is the team that knocked them out, upset them last year. University of New England. They'll be playing them tomorrow night, the Adirondack Bank Center. I've got my tickets. Do you have yours? We want to fill the odd tomorrow night. This is going to be a great game. If they win this game, the Frozen Four will be played in Utica.
Yeah, it's very
next
exciting.
Next weekend.
Very exciting.
And that'll be Friday and Sunday, right, if we can win this thing.
Yes.
Now, remember, this is the team in the quarterfinals, the very same spot at the odd last year that beat Utica 2-0. And let's make sure that doesn't happen again.
No, absolutely.
I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to Heenan. We're not going to let that happen again. That will not happen again. And today, if you're keeping track, New Hartford is playing in the Final Four in the Class A New York State Championship in boys basketball. If you have any interest, the team will be leaving the New Hartford. I believe it's the Rec Center. We'll have to clear that up this morning. But they'll be leaving. Their bus is leaving at 10 a.m., and they're asking for people in the village and people in the neighborhood to kind of cheer them off, cheer their bus off as they head out to play in Glens Falls later on today. This is a big, surprising move for New Hartford, right? They weren't expected to go this far this year.
I do think, though, they were, when the tournament started, they were ranked 13th or 14th in the state, which is obviously great for them. I believe, was it Weed Sport? It's the Syracuse school that's ranked number one in the state. They're still involved in it. And, boy.
Yeah, is it Liverpool? Is it Liverpool?
I thought it was Weed Sport.
Look at this. Is that the back of the Rome Sentinel, Davey?
Yeah.
Look at that. That's pretty cool. Go New Hartford Spartans. And today's, is that today's paper? Today's Rome Sentinel. On the back, it's a full-page ad. Go Spartans. Pretty cool. What else do I have here? How about the story out of Oneida County? The prisoner arrested after an officer was attacked, punched in the face. Maybe we can grab Sheriff Machel on this one as well. A prisoner in the Oneida County Jail was arrested again after attacking a corrections officer. Tahar M. Hicks attacked a corrections officer that was bringing him, he was bringing him a meal on a tray at 5:30 on Sunday, according to the sheriff's office. He punched the officer in the face and then drew him on the ground. Other officers arrived and restrained Hicks, stopping the incident from going any further. The officer had to be taken to St. E's, where he was treated for a chipped tooth, cut on his face, and a fractured kneecap.
Ooh.
How much is this going to continue to happen?
Yeah, it's ridiculous. It seems to happen, it certainly seems to be happening more and more.
And
but,
their argument is they can't punish the inmates when something like this happens the way they used to be able to punish them.
Yeah, it's I wonder how that breaks down in the county jail, because I don't know if they have, they must have a single housing unit in the county jail.
I don't know how they do it. And maybe we can grab Sheriff Machel as well. Hicks charged with second-degree assault, according to deputies. He's been held in the jail since November, according to jail records. So, you know, what is happening here? And whatever happened to, you know, you're in the county jail. It's not like you're spending life in prison. Why would you want to to further your sentence? Why would you want to have to stay there any longer?
No, you're
and
right.
Now you're in deep. Now you've attacked and sent a sheriff's deputy to the hospital. Not good.
No. A broken kneecap. That sounds extremely painful.
This morning on the program, we got into it a little bit with this Utica Council drama. Mm-hmm. I find that in Utica, and I'm not saying anything negatively. I'm just finding in Utica, we find the oddest places to get the drama, don't we?
Yes.
I mean, there's a mayor's race. There's a little drama going on there, and you'd expect that in the mayor's race. Do you remember, like, the county clerk's race? There was drama in the county clerk's race.
Yes.
Who would have thought? But there was last year. Now this year, there's drama in one of the council races, and it's all about residency.
Yeah, we'll talk to Katie Aiello later this morning. You know, when I scheduled her to come on, she said basically that she had been dealing with this, that it, I don't know if it was a private investigator or an investigator with the district attorney's office had been to her home. And I thought she had said that it had all been cleared up. But then, of course, we talked to Russ Pelley yesterday, who brought up allegations that she doesn't live there. And he's talking about this and sent a copy of it, this signed, I don't know if you want to call it an affidavit. It looks like just some typing on a piece of paper that says, this person, it says, like, Katie Aiello, a.k.a. Katie Martin, a.k.a. Katie Martin Aiello, a.k.a. Martin Katie Aiello. There's like four or five names that they listed there. Does not live at this address.
And this is for a council position. I just don't understand. There's so much drama and controversy over it. Yesterday, I had a chance to drive around with Katie Aiello, and she was pointing out some of the different houses, and this is what she had to say. This is where we used to live, right over here.
This is where we used to live.
Yeah, right up there, see the window? Right up there, the window was my bedroom.
Broken glass, broken hungry, broken hearts and broken bones. This is where we used to live.
I'm telling you, we lived there. Lived there. That's where we live.
Somebody's saying this morning, can't you call the post office? They can tell you where she lives.
I would say it's where, you know, where is your mail going? And you, there's tax information, right? When you fill out your tax form, you got to be able to place your residency, where you live. I don't know. It's just a crazy. But we have her on, and I give her a great deal of credit that she's coming on today. She's going to talk about it. And her opponent and her opponent's fiance, they're doing all of this investigating, and it even got deep into speaking with a priest. There's a priest involved, a man of God, who apparently says, "No, this is not where she used to live. Maybe it is, but she doesn't live here now." So this is all craziness. Now, it is Utica law that you must live in the district in order to be a council person. So not only do you have to live in the city, but you must live in the district. So this is going to be very interesting. We'll see what happens.
And not to be just, you know, giving out addresses, et cetera, but I believe this is in the area of the Ukrainian church that was...
We were doing all... That was raising all of the money for pierogi.
Yes.
And
right,
they were
doing
selling,
the pierogi sales.
They were
yes.
selling all that and sending it over to Ukraine.
Yes.
A man in Illinois accused of killing his estranged wife. Did you see this story? This is just nuts. A man in Illinois accused of killing his estranged wife made a disparaging joke about their marriage years earlier on Family Feud. Here's Timothy Billenfrick.
Oh, my goodness.
During his appearance on Family Feud.
What the f*** that you made at your wedding?
Honey, I love you, but said I do. Not my mistake. I love my wife. I'm going to get in trouble for that, aren't I?
Yeah.
Well, and years later, he would kill her.
Honey, I love you, but said I do?
I don't even know what that means.
Yeah, I don't get it. I don't know what the question was. But
I'm with you on that one.
So ultimately, wait a minute. That guy that we just heard murdered his wife who's on the show with him?
Yeah, well, you know, Family Feud, they bring up the whole family stuff. Yeah, yeah. Illinois, accused of killing his estranged wife, made the joke there on about marriage on Family Feud, and then has recently been charged with killing his wife.
Honey, I love you, but I said I do. I don't get it. Anyway.
Someone attacked the, and I think this is an unfair attack because this is the drummer with only one arm. Am I right? The Def Leppard drummer. Rick Allen has only one arm. I saw him perform in Albany. It was unbelievable. I mean, he can do things on a drum set with his legs and one arm that it would astound you.
Yeah, that's incredible.
Yeah. Anyway, the drummer was attacked while he was standing outside the Four Seasons Hotel in Fort Lauderdale. A 19-year-old Ohioan named Max Hartley allegedly ran at full speed and knocked the drummer to the ground, where he hit his head. A woman tried to intervene, and then he assaulted her, even dragging the woman back outside the hotel when she tried to escape into the lobby. Following the attacks, 911 callers reported they apprehended Hartley after he tried to break a restaurant's window by throwing chairs. I'm telling you, this is all drugs. These people get they get nuts. They go crazy. Yeah. He was caught later vandalizing cars in a parking lot. He probably didn't even know he did that. He probably was a fan. He's probably a fan of Def Leppard and didn't even know he did it. He was charged with abuse of an elderly or disabled adult because the drummer from Def Leppard is old today.
He's probably 70-something.
He was charged. Not only does he only have one arm, but he's old, for God's sakes. He was charged with abuse of an elderly or disabled adult with great harm.
Oh, I'm sorry. He's only 59.
That's old. You feel old. Rick Allen is 59. He lost his arm in a 1984 car accident. He was in town to play the Seminole Hard Rock. Hartley's attorney said he's an extremely sweet young man. He's never been in trouble with the law. The lawyer didn't comment on what provoked the attacks. This is him talking about Hartley. What provoked the attacks, nor whether Rick Allen, being a band member in Def Leppard, played any part in it. Witnesses say Hartley was heavily intoxicated. Here is, that'll do it every time.
Wow.
Here's audio. That's him on the drums right there. Anyway, yeah.
Yeah, that's...
Again, amazing to see. You can pull it up on YouTube, the way he's able to drum. Today, happy St. Patrick's Day.
And happy birthday to our man, Uncle Smitty.
Davey is celebrating number 48.
Thank you, Jeff. Yeah. Thank you, Bill.
Yeah.
I didn't wear green today, and you didn't either, huh?
Well, I didn't wear green either.
Yeah. Well, it's St. Patrick's Day.
That's
happy
so 1980s.
St. Patrick's Day. What else did I want to get to? We have Willie Waffle coming up in just a second.
And the other sheriff will touch base with him.
Mike
as well.
Says, well, I guess it really was a family feud between this guy and his wife. Ba-dum-tsh, you're right.
Yeah.
A thief in Sacramento attempted to steal a helicopter from an airport, ended up crashing it. Here's FBI Special Agent Sean Reagan talking about some of the reasons why someone would want to steal a helicopter.
What is the motive? But the scope would be almost anything you can think of. It could be somebody wanting to take an aircraft for a joyride. It could be somebody wanting to take an aircraft to do some sort of other criminal activity with it, some kind of damage to some other property, whatnot. Terrorism, of course.
Yeah. What would you do with a helicopter? You have to know how to operate a helicopter.
Yeah, I was going to say.
I think it's almost easier, and I don't know. But I would, maybe a pilot would tell us. I would say it's easier to fly an airplane than it is to fly a helicopter.
Probably, yeah. I wouldn't steal a helicopter. I wouldn't know what to do with it.
Right,
I couldn't even turn the thing on.
You're right.
How far did they get? Or it was attempting to steal a helicopter?
Attempting to.
Attempting.
Yeah. The person has not been caught yet, actually, but is believed to be critically hurt in the... Oh, no, he got it up and then it crashed. That's why you don't take off with a helicopter.
What a moron.
Yeah. Some Florida beachgoers are upset after having unexpected encounters with... nudists. Last week it was the bike riders in Daytona, the bikers.
Yeah.
It was bike week. This week it's the nudists. Some Florida beachgoers dealing with nudists at a popular stretch of the beach. The confusion comes from the fact that last year the signs marking these beaches for nude sunbathing were washed away by a hurricane. Here are some people upset because they saw so many nude beachgoers on the beach.
It was uncomfortable. She was covering her eyes.
And there's big fat guys laying there like this. No, I don't want to see that kind of stuff.
There's no law against being nude. Frustrated because there was no sign. There was no warning for us to know what we were going to experience. My husband noticed that they were both doing lewd acts to themselves.
Oh, lovely. That's nice. That always comes in handy,
right?
Doesn't it? No pun intended. The reality is, can you imagine that woman? She's like, there were two fat guys just lying there on their backs. I said, don't look. It was too late. Can you imagine if a guy said there were two fat women?
Bill, I thought the same exact thing.
It's okay. It's okay to pick on the portly male. But God forbid, if that was a woman, you'd be in big trouble for that.
Also, you said it happened along a popular stretch along the beach. I just wonder, as a nudist, what would your most popular stretch be?
Yeah, that's right. I believe it's the one where you go like this, and you put your arms up and yawn a little bit. Stretch that out. There you go. And Bono paid tribute to his longtime friends, ABBA, yesterday on BBC Radio 2. He decided to cover ABBA's SOS. I just can't imagine Bono and U2 covering SOS. Can you, and any ABBA song, to be honest with you.
No, I'm still stuck on the ABBA on the BBC.
That's a good point. Here's the audio and what it sounded like. And they were backed up by six female cellists. Here we go.
The love you gave me, nothing else can save me. SOS. When you're gone, how can I even try to go on?
Okay, all right.
When you're gone, though I try, how can I carry on?
All right. Okay. I guess I'm okay with that.
Yeah, I guess that was nice.
I guess I'm all right. I want to get an update on the story we were talking about here where the sheriff's deputy was attacked by an inmate. I believe it's line, this is third line here, Davey, line three. All right, let's try it. Sheriff Rob Machel is on the line right now. Sheriff, good morning.
Good morning, guys. How are you today?
Good. Does the county jail have the same problem the prisons are having where you are in a position where the inmates know they can't be punished, so there's no repercussion to do something like this?
Absolutely. County jails across the state, like state correctional facilities, are seriously affected by the HALT Act. Couple things here that even if we step further back in time a little bit, with the evolution of bail reform and all the changes that have come with that, certainly has affected jail population. What we end up now is with basically some of the most dangerous people in our custody than ever before. In addition to that, with the closures of mental health facilities and the lack of mental health programs out in the community, you end up with a lot of mental health patients in our facility that in many cases need to be somewhere else, not in jail. Then the HALT Act, which takes away nearly everything that in previous years we could use as a consequence for inmates who fail to follow the rules. This particular case, as reported in the release, the officer was dispersing meals, and that obviously at the time he was attacked by an individual who's currently in on some very serious violent felony charges. Looking at some significant time in state prison, who in many cases, knows that even though he's in facing serious charges and is now charged with, felony assault on a corrections officer, he's still entitled to his time outside of his cell as, sarcastically, I'll call it playtime, 7 hours a day where he can still come out of the cell and get his free time and whatnot. So it's very, very, very frustrating for correction officers across this state where they're in danger. And, it's just their job is tougher and tougher each and every single day.
Yeah, it is. It's more difficult every single day. It's just unbelievable. And in this case, though, he's going to now have to face these charges, which will be most likely added on to his current sentence.
Exactly. Obviously, he was charged with the attack on the corrections officer, and certainly when it gets to that point, I hope that whatever judge wherever ends up when sentencing time comes, we our goal certainly is to have time added on to, not time put together with. It's a serious case. Now, not only has the officer received injuries, he's going to need dental work now. I was at hospital with him that night when this happened. I did go to the responded to the hospital to be with him, but now obviously he's going to go through some challenging recovery. He wants to get back to work, and he will, but my point is now he's out of work. There was a second officer who was injured not by this inmate but while responding to assist this corrections officer. So now we've got two officers out, which it puts additional strain on an already understaffed, overtaxed facility, staff. It's just it's a mess. And the system in New York State has continued to hamper and put our officers in danger every single day. And I don't know what it's going to take for lawmakers downstate to wake up.
I completely agree. It's just it's mind blowing at this point. So many of these things are happening, and it's so clear that there needs to be we got to revert back to at least putting these people in a position where they have a little bit of they know a repercussion. They know something bad is coming if they get out of line and do something like this, especially something violent like this. It
exactly.
just doesn't make
there
any sense.
There has to be consequences. And like I said, the atmosphere is just, it's the most dangerous time for corrections officers and police officers across the state. And I'm just getting so frustrated following these past couple days of, you know, the last minute budget bills from our assembly and our Senate and, you know, the governor, we were hopeful she was making some changes in the positive direction, but it looks like there's zero to little support from downstate lawmakers who control everything. And it appears as though it's going to get worse for us as we go through 23 here.
And Sheriff, I just wanted to mention yesterday when we had Mike Hennessy on, he did reference your endorsement by the Conservative Party and the Democrats as well, and the Republicans. I didn't mention yesterday, because the voters really did decide. You now hold the record, I'm pretty sure, at least in Oneida County, for the most conservative votes ever. Am I correct with that?
That is correct. Obviously, not only did I get the most votes on the conservative line this year, but I've gotten the most votes at any candidate on a conservative line in general, not just Democrat, but any candidate who's ever been endorsed by the conservatives in Oneida County. I received more votes than ever before with, I believe it was nearly 19,000 people voted for me on the conservative line. And I kind of chuckled, you know, when I listened to him yesterday, you know, and he was upset that I endorsed the county executive. Well, I'll endorse him again, and I will endorse him again, because he's doing a great job. And again, it's not about what party we belong to. It's about what we're doing and doing the right thing for Oneida County. And it's just, it's unfortunate, but, you know, he's done two media interviews that I know of so far with different outlets, and he spends half his time talking about the sheriff. I don't understand what I've got to do with his potential, which isn't going to work out, but his desire to be the county executive.
Sheriff, we appreciate your time. Thank you.
Sounds great, guys. Have a good day.
You do the same. And what is was happening to these, whether we're talking about the county jail with deputies or in the state facilities, this is just a real problem that's got to be addressed. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, and part of what he was talking about, too, was how the sentences are, I guess, doled out, essentially. So he said that this particular individual could be facing a lengthy sentence if they're convicted on their other crime allegation. So it's like, well, if I was going to get 10 years and then you give me five more consecutive, that's 15 years.
Right,
concurrently.
Right.
10 right. plus 5 plus 3 plus 8 plus 1 is still only 10.
Right.
So.
Yeah. Well, you would think assaulting a deputy will carry a little weight, I would think, in court. Willie Waffle reviews everything media, and that includes the movie theaters as well. I found a movie, Willie, that is coming out this summer that I totally will go to the theater to see. I mean, you got to move me to get me to go to the theater now. That seems to be the world we live in. But this Oppenheimer looks like it's
Eufreda?
Right up, Oppenheimer, Eufreda. Oppenheimer looks like it's going to be a brilliant movie to check out.
Yeah, that looks really, really good. You know, from director Christopher Nolan, a guy who's done some great movies over the years. Yeah, I mean, just, you know, who would have thought you could take what's basically a scientific movie and make it so dramatic and so compelling? And you know, maybe I'm selling it short, because, I mean, we are talking about something that changes humanity. We're talking about an invention that you know, really changes the course of history.
Yeah, yeah. And then I have to say, we watched, we're on to a few things now. The Stranger Things, man, that is out there.
Strange,
but it's intense to watch. We've got, like, I don't know, two episodes left. That's been out there for a while. The other one.
Are you on the last season?
Yeah.
Or are you? Okay.
And then My wife got into watching the Addams Family's Wednesday.
Yeah.
And I know she's in the news right now because she's apparently not an easy person to work for.
She's been running her mouth a lot.
Oh, yeah. Like, she's like, these people didn't know how to write. I had to rewrite everything. It's like, okay, you do want to get another job, right?
God. You know what it reminds me of? I don't know if you guys ever watched the show Friends, but there was an episode of Friends where Joey, who's an actor, had finally hit it big. He is on Days of Our Lives. And he does this interview where he's like, oh, yeah, I rewrite the lines all the time. And he walks in the next day, and they've killed him off.
That's right. He's gone. He's done. And this is like, this was directed by Tim Burton. It's not like these are, you know, a bunch of newbies out there. So,
well, and the amazing thing, too, you know, like, so after this whole experience where, you know, now it's all coming out that she was extremely difficult to deal with. She seems to be proud of how difficult she was to deal with. There's a lot of talk right now. Tim Burton is putting together Beetlejuice 2, and she's the front runner right now to star in that movie.
He's negotiating with her right now. And it's like, well, we'll take her crap. She really does well at the box office, so I think we're going to – not that this was even in the box office, but, Willie, it was so well-produced. You thought you were watching, especially the finale, the last episode, you thought you were watching a movie in the theater. I mean, these streaming episodes and series and movies that they're putting out on Netflix or wherever, they're epic. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, and these streaming outlets had, I say had, you know, a ton of money to throw at these things and improve the quality and really raise the level. But that seems to be dialing back now. You know, a lot of the streamers are now under a lot of pressure to produce a profit for the big corporations that own them. So, you know, like yesterday, Disney Plus announced they're getting rid of their Willow show after one season. You know, surprises like that keep coming up.
Interesting. And then we're watching, of course, the soccer Ted Lasso.
Ted Lasso.
It's back. But you know what they did with this? They used to put it out, and all the episodes would be laid out. You could binge watch it over the weekend. Now it's one episode a week. They're tempering your binge watching.
Yeah, I don't like that at all. I think that that's a big mistake. I think Netflix hit it big because you could stream it. You could watch as much as you wanted, when you wanted, and you didn't have to wait a week. And I would be interested to see the numbers. I wonder if they have shows that start off strong but, like, die off over the course of a number of weeks because people are like, I'm just tired of waiting. I'm not as interested anymore. Something new just came out.
Yep,
I mean, I think they killed their own buzz.
I agree. I think it's a big mistake. And then in theaters, quickly, 3 minutes. In theaters, what are we looking at?
Well, you know, you've got Shazam, the Fury of the Gods.
Oh,
yes,
boy.
Shazam is back.
Lovely.
And maybe he should have stayed away. It's just... You know, here's the thing. So it's a sequel to the one that came out way before COVID, right? And it was fun. And it was exciting. And it's this whole story of this 14-year-old kid who gets, you know, given the power to be a superhero. And, you know, he's a stupid 14-year-old kid with it. And in this movie, we find out that power came from, well, three gods played by Helen Mirren, Lucy Liu, and Rachel Zegler. And they're angry. And they want revenge. And they come hunting him and his buddies down. And it's just very boring, very flat. It doesn't have the energy and the fun that the first one did. And it just seems to be a CGI movie. I'm going 1.5 waffles on Shazam.
And that's really it for the big ones out there, right?
That's really it. I mean, you know, if you want to flip over to Hulu, they have a new movie, Boston Strangler, which is really interesting with Keira Knightley and Carrie Coon playing these two female reporters in the 60s who kind of get on the story of the Boston Strangler. And, they're, you know, Keira Knightley is kind of the first one who puts the pieces together that there's a serial killer at play here. And in following that case, I thought that was really interesting.
Yeah.
I think... You know, if you want to check that out, I'm going like 3 waffles on Boston Strangler.
Wow. All right. We'll look for that. And then I can't believe they're bringing Matlock back.
I know, right? We've hit the bottom of the barrel.
Yeah.
Like this is it. You are done with reboots and rehashing and sequels when you do a Matlock reboot with Kathy Bates as Matlock.
She's going to be Matlock. So it won't be a guy playing Matlock. That's
no,
crazy.
And you know, and the idea is, you know, she's this, you know, Southern lawyer with all of her crazy ways that goes to work for a big law firm, and maybe the partners don't always appreciate what she does.
Okay. Great stuff, Willie. Enjoy the week, and we'll talk next week. Thank you.
All right. Talk to you next week.
Willie Waffle. By the way, Michael's on fire this morning. I want to catch that movie playing at the Palatine Bridge Drive-In. That must be great because it's been playing for months. The movie's called Closed for the Season. Mike, I love it. We got a break, and we have a comedian in studio. He's awesome. We'll talk to him coming up in a second. 7 o'clock, WIBX, Utica, Rome.
To Russia with support. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News. China's leader will go to Moscow next week, and Xi Jinping plans to be there Monday to Wednesday. The U.S. has warned the Chinese not to give Russia weapons to use in its ongoing war in Ukraine, which the Chinese foreign minister says could spin out of control, urging his Ukrainian counterpart to hold peace talks with Russia. This days after Russia took down an American drone over the Black Sea.
Pentagon officials tell Fox News the order to aggressively harass a U.S. drone over the Black Sea came from Russian leadership. It ended with the drone damaged and ditched in the water. Russia dispatched ships to recover the wreckage. Pentagon officials say the Russian Navy recovered nothing of value.
Fox's Mike Tobin in Kyiv, Ukraine. 11 banks, including Chase and Citigroup, have grouped together to try to save another one considered at risk. They've deposited $30 billion into First Republic following the recent failures of Silicon Valley and Signature Banks. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen told a Senate hearing the U.S. banking system is sound.
And that Americans can feel confident that their deposits will be there when they need them.
Senators asked why Signature Bank poured its money into risky investments. The GOP says inflation triggered higher interest rates, and that cost SVB. Democrats said well-heeled interest softened banking regulations 5 years ago.
That's Fox's Chad Pergram. A setback in court for North Dakota in an attempt to ban abortions. The state Supreme Court allowing a lower court order blocking it to stay in place after a clinic sued.
The Chief Justice writing that while lawmakers have the authority to regulate abortion, the clinic has shown likely success on the merits of the case. Courts have blocked bans in several other states, too, while 14 states have abortion bans in effect.
Fox's Lisa Brady is up to 10 people now charged with second-degree murder in the death of a black man at a Virginia mental hospital earlier this month, seven of them sheriff's deputies. Irvo Otieno's family says video shows he was already in handcuffs and leg irons when deputies held him down, pushing him to the ground. A prosecutor says he was smothered, died of asphyxiation. America's listening to Fox News.
Progressive presents 10 things on a contractor's to-do list that are harder than getting a commercial auto insurance quote. Bidding a new client, giving an accurate estimate, finding affordable materials, getting a client to pay you for work you already did, getting a client to pay you, period, securing permits and workers and tools, getting those workers and tools to work together, and finding the perfect pair of overalls. Pockets, baby. But the easiest thing on a small business owner's to-do list? Seeing if you can save on commercial auto insurance. Get a quote in as little as 6 minutes at progressivecommercial.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Coverage subject to policy terms and conditions.
Maxwell, she was scratching and losing some hair. My vet, she says, oh, he must be allergic to chicken. Another vet says, eat the grain. Third vet says, it's the weather. Then somebody said,
DINOVITE.com.
It took 2 weeks, and the dog stopped itching. The hair stopped falling out. The Dynavite is a big part of Maxwell's diet.
You get some Dynavite, how happy your dog will be.
DINOVITE.com.
Mostly cloudy skies, 36 degrees. WIBX news time is 7:03. This news update is brought to you by MyCarl's Lucky Triple Bonus Sale. With three bonuses to choose from, save on your sales tax, get a free area rug or free interest for one full year. MyCarl's in the New Hartford Shopping Center and in Destiny, USA. A prisoner at the Oneida County Jail in some legal trouble after being accused of injuring a corrections officer. Officials say Todger Hicks allegedly assaulted the victim while the officer was bringing him a meal. Hicks allegedly punched the officer in the face before throwing him to the ground. The officer needed treatment for a chipped tooth, a cut on his face, and a fractured kneecap. Hicks, who has been in custody since November, is facing new charges of assault. After being shut down for the last 3 years, Amtrak is ready to again roll out the popular Adirondack line connecting New York City and Montreal, along with more than a dozen stops in between. The Adirondack line was shut down in March of 2020 during the COVID-19 pandemic because of travel restrictions between the U.S. and Canada, but Amtrak officials have announced it will be returning effective Monday, April 3rd. A former aide to former New York Governor Andrew Cuomo, who accused him of sexual harassment, is now suing New York State. Charlotte Bennett filed a lawsuit this week saying the state should be liable for Cuomo's alleged actions. Bennett has already filed a separate lawsuit against Cuomo and his former top aides, alleging sexual harassment and retaliation. Cuomo has denied those allegations. In this story, Bill, the state attorney general's office is looking into how a phone number connected to Rochester Gas and Electric was able to make it over and be taken over by scammers. A false toll-free customer service number was printed on bills that went out to customers, and it gave scammers the chance to commit fraud. The company is asking people who require a TTY line to now dial 711 for help. Folks who believe they've been scammed can contact the attorney general's office, but it was on the bill.
They're getting better and better at this. And one has to hope that we will, as the scammers get better, we will get better. So the, you know, the every time Apple does one of these, I'm an iPhone person. So every time you're told, hey, you better do a, you have to do this new update on your iPhone, I think it's important to get it done, right?
Absolutely.
I see you are somewhat distracted. Is there something going on over there?
No.
Let's do the weather. Or do you have more to do?
No, that's it. Your forecast comes to you from Eyewitness News Chief Meteorologist Craig Flint.
From the WIBX Weather Center, I'm Eyewitness News Meteorologist Craig Flint. Mainly light rain showers area-wide today. Light rain tapers to scattered showers, turning windy and colder late. High 46. Tonight, mainly cloudy sky, blustery, colder, a few snow flurries, a low near 30. I'm meteorologist Craig Flint on WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM.
Mostly cloudy and 36. It is 7:06. All right, in sports, we'll touch base on a few things here. Can't get to all of the NCAA tournament action, but a key piece of the Eagles' defense staying in Philly. ESPN says Darius Slay agreeing to a 3-year, $42 million contract. The majority of NCAA tournament brackets have been busted. 15th-seeded Princeton pulled off a shocking 59-55 upset of second-seeded Arizona in the South region, and 13th-seed Furman also advanced in the South after knocking off 4th-seed Virginia, 68-67. And in the East, 4th-seed Tennessee fended off a late rally by number 13 Louisiana. It was also a dominant showing for the number 1 seeds Alabama, Kansas, and Houston, who all advanced to the second round. Unfortunately, Colgate could not get going, fell behind early, and lost by 20. Shohei Ohtani and Japan were dominant en route to a 9-3 win over Mike Piazza and Italy in the World Baseball Classic quarterfinals in Tokyo. Ohtani scored 2 runs at the plate, striking out 5 as well, allowing 2 earned runs as he earned the win on the mound. WBC quarterfinal action continues today with Puerto Rico challenging Mexico in Miami. The news is as bad as we thought. New York.
I can't believe this. It is as bad as we had feared.
New York Mets closer Edwin Diaz reportedly out for the season with a knee injury. The team announced he underwent a successful repair of the patellar tendon in his right knee on Thursday. He's already had surgery. The injury happened while he was celebrating a win pitching for his native Puerto Rico during the World Baseball Classic. Not clear how he was injured while celebrating, but he could be seen limping off the field before getting into a wheelchair. Unbelievable. 3 players tied atop the leaderboard after the first round at the Valspar Championship. Adam Schenck, Ryan Brehm, and Steven Yeager, I believe that is. The Utica Pioneers in action at the Adirondack Bank Center tomorrow night. 7 o'clock start?
7 p.m. start at the Adirondack Bank Center.
The University of New England is the opponent, and it's the quarterfinal round?
Quarterfinal round.
Quarterfinal round. Round the bend, and it's a... a big night of hockey action tomorrow night at the Adirondack Bank Center in Utica. How you doing?
I'm pretty excited about that tomorrow night. I think it's going to be enormous. And, you know, this will be playing in the background, somebody's cars, they're tailgating and getting ready or whatever. But it's a big deal. This is the game they lost last year to the same team, 2-0. They couldn't get the offense going. My prediction for tomorrow night, there'll be a lot of offense for Utica. I just have a feeling. Hopefully we'll get Gary Heenan before he goes into practice this morning coming up. All right, we'll get into Katie Aiello in a minute. She's running for her seat in the Common Council, and there's all of this stuff happening over, does she actually live in the city? I don't know. Does she? Has she? We'll speak with her coming up in a second. 7:09 at WIBX on Friday morning.
Step into spring with Adirondack Home Furniture and quality furniture that's sure to enhance any living space. Whether it be for your great room, your new home office, or outside patio, Adirondack Home Furniture has your style. From modern to farmhouse, rustic to transitional, handcrafted pieces that are totally customizable and are built for enduring use. Beautiful sofas and reclining furniture from Flex Steel, designer fabrics and top brand leathers. With free local delivery and a knowledgeable staff, you'll have your dream home in no time. Adirondack Home Furniture has a large line of quality USA-made furniture from top manufacturers. Our salespeople are non-commissioned, which means you enjoy a relaxing, non-stressful experience. So stop in today to Adirondack Home Furniture for living rooms, dining rooms, bedrooms, and home office. You'll find everything you need for your dream home. Adirondack Home Furniture at Riverside Center in North Utica or at AdirondackHomeFurniture.com. Create the home of your dreams with Adirondack Home Furniture.
Go green and save green right now at City Suburban. There has never been a better way to heat and cool your home than with a new Mitsubishi electric heat pump system from City Suburban. They provide energy-efficient comfort year-round, are whisper quiet, 40% more efficient than conventional systems, and offer room-by-room temperature control. And the best part is right now you can save up to $9,000 in rebates with the New York State Clean Heat Program while funds are available. Go green and make the switch today, and as always, receive City Suburban's POMG. That's peace of mind guarantee.
This is Chris from City Suburban on Route 233 in Westmoreland. There has never been a better time to upgrade your system than right now. You can save up to $9,000 with New York State clean heat rebates and make your home more comfortable and efficient for years to come. Call us today at 853-3899. That's 853-3899, or visit us at citysuburban.com.
It feels good to know someone has your best interest at heart. At AmeriCue, we'll help you make the most of your money. Whether you're a savvy investor or just starting to build your savings, earn more with AmeriCue. From competitive rates to expert guidance and quick and easy online account opening, AmeriCue has everything you need to get more out of life. AmeriCue and you, let's connect. Membership eligibility is required. Insured by NCUA.
Paid for by Altimetry Research.
Despite Joe Biden's age, raging inflation, and his dismal 45% approval level, one Pentagon consultant believes Biden could become one of the most powerful presidents in history. How is this all possible? Well, it's almost entirely because of a surprising July 25th twist that hardly anyone's talking about right now. A powerful new economic force is quietly building behind Joe Biden, and Biden can harness this force's inevitable wave, carrying him to a landslide re-election win. The good news is, this powerful new force can help you make a lot of money, even in a bear market. The bad news is, this July 25th twist is also likely to make Biden and the progressives more powerful than ever, meaning much bigger government, and it's going to be harder than ever to hold on to any money you make. After being asked to speak at the Pentagon recently in Washington, D.C., this insider put together an analysis of this situation, which details everything you need to know. You can access his full, brand new analysis free of charge by visiting BidenElection100.com. BidenElection100.com.
Hi, I'm Max Carbone, sales manager at Power Sports Utica. We are currently overstocked on 2023 Ski-Doo models, and we are offering up to $2,000 off sticker plus a $500 gift card for anything in the store. Kawasaki KLR models have $1,000 in rebates as well, and we have all colors and trims available in stock and ready for delivery. Kawasaki KLX models have $400 in rebate and up to $1,500 off KX models. Come visit us at Power Sports Utica, Central New York's Four Seasons Toy Store.
Menthol is not just a flavor. It's a manipulative way for big tobacco to target, attract, and addict Black Americans. Tobacco companies aggressively market menthol products using elements of Black culture, putting more products on shelves in Black communities and making them cheaper. And it's not just an injustice, it's killing us. Smoking-related illnesses are the number one cause of death in the African American community. Help us fight this injustice at notjustmenthol.org.
Every day at NBT Bank, we focus our business around all the ways we can help yours. We're large enough to offer leading business and digital solutions, but local enough to ensure personalized one-on-one service. So turn to NBT Bank for a full range of business solutions, like capital and treasury management services, even fraud protection, and see how NBT Bank is just the right size to help you do big things. Visit nvtbank.com to learn more and start a conversation. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
So if it's flooring, it's in Sarah's Flooring Outlet, the area's leading store for flooring. They have the largest inventory in all of Central New York at their Route 49 Plaza. And if it's Pergo Extreme by Mohawk, they have the price guarantee. It's a 60-mile radius of the store. They'll guarantee the lowest price, the best install. And we're talking about the best flooring, a deeper protection, layered construction, offering the best protection against wear and dents. You know, if you get this this flooring and you don't get good flooring, it doesn't last. Pergo Extreme is top of the line, 100% dent-proof, waterproof, kid-proof, pet-proof, and only at Enceras will you get the price guarantee within a 60-mile radius. And if it's any kind of flooring, from tile to hardwoods, whatever it is you're looking for, they have it. Go to their website, EnceresFlooringOutlet.com. Get a $50 off coupon for your next purchase. And you can get 6 months interest-free financing. We had hardwood floors put in our home, and it was pure craftsmanship. A beautiful product, and it just elevates the value of your home. 6 months interest-free financing right now at Enceras Flooring Outlet, Route 49 Plaza, River Road, Marcy, online in sarahsflooringoutlet.com.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
All right, Michael Harrison is the comedian this weekend at Fat Cats Comedy Club and is in studio. Michael, good morning.
Hey, good morning, buddy. How you doing?
So how did you get here? You don't drive. Davey was he was completely bothered at the fact that...
I love it. You called me out this early.
You don't have a car. There's no car.
I don't. Oh, no, I don't.
So, but you,
I live in New York City, though.
You
no
don't
one
need
has a car, right?
Right.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
A car is a problem in New York City.
Yeah. Plus, like, I fly all over, right? Like, I fly, what is it, whether it be Europe or Asia or even Canada or
you can't take a car. There to
it's
Europe.
Pointless, yeah, yeah. Right? For insurance, all that stuff in New York City.
It's the parking that'll kill you.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not driving to Ireland. Forget it. I don't know that route. Is there an interstate for that?
And where are you going to park once you cross the ocean?
I mean,
where
exactly, are you parking? Exactly. Exactly.
So you have a dry bar special that is out. Explain what dry bar specials are for those.
Oh man, those are specials actually made for like Christians and Mormons. So it's like all clean comedy. It's all just anyone. I should just say anyone who likes clean comedy. But
those people too.
Yeah, yeah, I guess them as well, right? But it's in Utah, so like the audience is like very, very religious. And then
is it really? Is that where it all comes from?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, Provo.
I didn't know that. I never knew that.
No? Do you know Dry Bar?
I don't. I thought it was a holdover from COVID. It's like...
Hilarious. Yeah, they got popular during COVID. That's
yeah,
for sure.
Right.
I mean, yeah, they have...
Why? Doesn't the alcohol kill the virus?
Yeah.
Exactly.
That's a good point.
Right?
So it is all clean. It's all, you know...
Yeah, unlike I think the show this weekend. This weekend is not.
This weekend is the opposite of that.
It's going to be a mix. I'll put it that way. Yeah?
And then you have a podcast out called, which is award winning, by the way.
I know. I'm the best.
Character. That's awesome. Character debate. I couldn't read my writing. What is character debates? What is that?
I make stand-up comedians debating character. So
okay.
It's all improvised. It's super goofy. So we had Jack Nicholson on. He was just on with a male nurse, and they debated if actors should get awards.
So that is really cool.
Yeah, it's our Oscar episode. So comedians impersonate all the characters. We had someone play Jack Nicholson, someone play the nurse, and then they debate. And they don't know the questions ahead of time.
Okay.
And then we've had a ton of them. Like our next one, we have a robot debating a Walmart cashier on should robots take over all customer service.
Right.
Right.
We might be better off.
Yeah, right? Yeah,
to be honest with you.
Hey, we had a caveman debate a Gen Zer on which generation had it the toughest. So it's like, it's pretty epic, man.
That's great.
Oh, you got to check it out. I love it.
The caveman, though, when you think about it, had just minimal basic responsibilities.
Yep.
It's like, go out and get the food, stay away from any of the big animals or anything like that. Right? Don't get eaten.
Yeah.
And that's it.
I know.
And then drag the woman around. I mean, think of what those guys had back then. That's terrible. When you think
about
it.
But you know what? That was a good point. The more I started researching it, I thought it was going to be like a slam dunk for the gay man. You're right. Gen Zers might have it tougher. Like
yeah.
You have it.
Yeah.
You all have pollution. You have the Kardashians. Right. They have to go through a lot. A lot,
yeah.
Bill.
Car insurance. Right. Some people have to worry about parking.
Is. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Very good point. I would like to. I'm going to have to tune in for that debate.
Oh, you have to. Check them all out.
So you just search.
We get everybody on. It's great.
Character debates.
Yep.
And that's all you. Okay.
That's funny. Our next guest is actually Character Coffee.
Right? It is.
That's the name of her coffee shop.
We'll bring her in a second. I'm very interested in that conversation. Magic Bill will be at the Fat Cats Comedy Club this weekend as well. Bill does up close magic as people are getting into their seats and that sort of thing. William, good morning.
Good morning, William. I just want to welcome Michael to town.
Thank you.
And looking forward to this weekend. Yeah. I got a little joke for you. Knock, knock.
Well, this is a knock, knock joke.
Oh, someone's going to tell me a joke.
Yeah,
it's auditioning here.
Okay, Bill.
Who's
knock,
there?
Knock, knock.
He said who's there. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't hear him. Weed.
Weed? Weed who?
We'd love everybody to come out to Fat Cats and have a good comedy weekend.
You ever see...
Got you, William.
You ever see... Oh, yeah, you got me. You got me, Bill. You got me. All right, William, you have a wonderful day and have fun, and we'll see you at Fat Cats.
Yeah, see you, Willie.
All right. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Yes, yeah, thank buddy. You. You too.
Didn't wear green either. Good for you, though, because none of us did.
I think
none of us did.
By the way, there.
I did a shout out for Ireland already, though, so I feel like I made up for it. I jumped on that quick.
There is. I mean, we had our parade last weekend because New York has their parade. I think today, right?
Oh, really?
Usually they have it on St. Patrick's Day.
Why would we make drunks like walk?
That's a very good point. Walk in
the
parade.
They're not very good at it. It seems very, very backwards to me.
Well, and you think parking is difficult, walking after you've had, I mean, they start early in the morning. I just saw it on TV. They're already gathering out there and getting ready. Ooh. But we had ours last weekend, so I don't think people are thinking, they're not in the St. Patrick's mood here right now. So.
As a matter of fact, I had no idea. A friend of mine said, we're going out for St. Patty's on Friday. And I go, what? And he goes, yeah, and then they got some specials going on Saturday on Varick Street. I'm like, it was last weekend. What do you think? He goes, no, St. Patrick's Day is Friday. We just did the parade last week. I had no idea.
This is the real deal. And on top of that, Davey's birthday falls every year on St. Patrick's Day.
Wow. And thank you for the well wishes coming in from the listeners. But if you would like to go to a parade, there's one in Old Forge at 5 o'clock today, and then Camden does theirs at 1 o'clock tomorrow.
Okay, so they're doing full right on St. Patrick's. Well, the day after for Camden.
Old Forge does theirs right on Main Street today at 5, and tomorrow right in downtown Camden at 1 o'clock.
All right. If you know, Davey's birthday is today. He's celebrating. And,
happy birthday, buddy.
He's 48 years old. I don't know if you'd guess that, but he is. Were you able to get around to the newspapers in his car? Did you move them, Davey?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
The back seat was full.
It was full of newspapers. Davey likes to read.
How good.
He reads a lot. So.
I didn't know if it was his bed or something. Yeah.
Actually, it just shows he's a hardworking man. When he gets out of here, you're off doing the work of the of the newspaper industry.
Right.
All right, stand by. I want a break. We're going to come back. I'm going to give you a little bit of a break. Get yourself together. We're going to get into it with Katie here in a second. The question is, does she live in Utica? Did she live in Utica? Because it is the law, according to, I guess it'd be the bylaws, in the city of Utica, to be a council person, you must live in the city. And there's a whole big investigation going on by her opponent and her opponent's fiance, they've interviewed people, even brought a man of God into the conversation. And we'll get into it with Katie coming up in a second. I do want to, before we break, speak with Frank from Tony's Pizzeria and Fat Cats Comedy Club. Frank is about ready to take off this morning and head to Glens Falls. His son plays on the New Hartford basketball team. And Frank, they want everybody to come out this morning, right?
Yeah. If people are interested, they want to come out and just send off the buses taking the kids to Glens Falls. It's 10 a.m. at the high school.
This has been for this basketball team, this has been a bit of a surprise. New Hartford was not expected to go as far as the Final Four. This has been a great finish to the season.
No, our record didn't speak Final Four. towards the end of the regular season. I think the biggest thing is, you know, we lost six seniors and four of them were big contributors to last year's team, sort of solidified what we do. And now, you know, this year we're just trying to find ourselves.
Yeah.
The biggest thing is, I mean, the chemistry and the coach did a really good job. I mean, realistically, we've had so many different starting lineups in the beginning and the middle of the season. And he's just trying to get kids to gel together. You know, we have an outside player, Jameson Stockwell, came from the Clinton district. And, you know, he's just, in the beginning, was just trying to fit in and find his role as well. So, you know, and we have three sophomores and a freshman, you know, that my son was the only sophomore that saw time last year. So, you know, we clicked at the right time. You know, we won six in a row, and we're finally starting to feel our groove, I guess.
Frank's son is a sophomore, and you might see him. You won't see him this weekend, but on a normal weekend, you'd see him at the comedy club. Frank,
I think I saw him. How old is he? 8 feet tall.
As a sophomore, your kid is enormous.
Yeah, he's 6'7". It was crazy. He's
6'7".
Water. It's like a chia pet.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. It's cannolis and pizza. That's all he lives on, and apparently that works. Although, Frank, I've grown in the other direction with the same foods. I don't know how he does it. So
I don't know what it is.
Yeah,
it's all luck of the draw, I guess.
All right, 10 a.m. Well, if you look at his parents, you would understand. 10 a.m. today. Is it from the rec center they're leaving, the high school?
No, actually right from the high school parking lot. They'll leave there. They'll get there all day, and our game's at 6 o'clock tonight against Tappan Zee.
And I guess I didn't know that Tappan Zee was actually a high school. So it must be a downstate school.
Well, I didn't know if they changed the school's name as they changed the bridge names. I
mean, right, did they change it to Cuomo?
Cuomo High School.
I kind of wonder. And the other part of this, if you're not heading up there, is there's a streaming service out there that, I don't know, it might cost you $6 or $7 or something for the month. You can
actually, what they do is it's $11.99 for a month.
Okay.
And it allows you to stream. It's actually pretty neat. It's NFHS Network.
Yes.
It allows you to stream high school sports around the country.
Yeah, I mean it's and that game will be, and it's done really well. You can obviously stream it up to your flat screen TV and watch it that way, or watch it on a computer or phone. But so look for that, subscribe to that, and you can watch the game tonight. Pretty cool.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Frank, thanks. Good luck.
Hey, thank you. Appreciate
it. New Hartford playing Tappan Zee tonight in the final four Class A state championship, 7:27. We'll do a quick break. We'll do a free money question of the day. We'll give away some tickets to Fat Cats Comedy Club. And then Katie Aiello waiting in the green room. We'll bring her in just a second. We'll chat with her about where she lives. An interesting line of questioning that I really haven't had with a politician or a member of the council before.
Same here.
But it's where we're going. 7:27 at WIBX.
It's truck season at DePonte Chevrolet. Find new roads with loads of inventory to choose from. Lease a 2023 Chevy Silverado Crew Cab LT, four-wheel drive all-star edition, 39-month lease, 10,000 miles a year for just $4.98 a month. Or purchase a 2022 Silverado Crew Cab Custom four-wheel drive Dark Essentials package. Get 2.9% financing for 72 months and receive $4,000 off. DePonte Chevy, your lucky charm this March. Visit them on Route 28 in Herkimer or at steeppontychevy.com. See why it's always easy to do business at DePonte Chevrolet.
Customer must qualify with top-tier credit with GM Financial. Lease offer stock number 23030. Must have current lease and household, 39-month lease, 10,000 miles per year, 25 cents per mile, penalty over 32,500 miles, $1,000 down, first payment, all taxes and fees due on delivery. Purchase offer, stock number 22471. Must own 2009 or newer Chevrolet and household. Must take delivery by March 31st, 2023.
I can't take this kitchen any longer. Carl, we need to start looking for a new house.
Honey, you know the housing market is tight. It's going to be next to impossible to find something that we like.
I know, but this kitchen has to go.
Hey, what about a home equity loan from Adirondack Bank? We can turn the equity from our home into cash to renovate, just the way you want.
Renovate?
Adirondack Bank has competitive rates, and they've been a trusted community bank for decades.
Hmm, a new kitchen. Wouldn't that be awesome?
Yeah.
Then, of course, we would need new furniture.
Well,
and we could repair the deck,
what?
Even add a pool, and take that trip to Italy that we've always talked about.
Whoa, slow down, honey. Let's go talk to the experts at Adirondack Bank about that home equity loan. Then we can decide where to start.
I've always wanted to add on a craft room,
ugh.
And our bathroom needs a facelift.
Don't move.
improve. Stop into your local Adirondack Bank branch for more information on a home equity loan.
Or visit AdirondackBank.com.
Bank local with Adirondack Bank, your hometown community bank.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Go green and save green right now at City Suburban. There has never been a better way to heat and cool your home than with a new Mitsubishi electric heat pump system from City Suburban. They provide energy-efficient comfort year-round, are whisper quiet, 40% more efficient than conventional systems, and offer room-by-room temperature control. And the best part is right now you can save up to $9,000 in rebates with the New York State Clean Heat Program while funds are available. Go green and make the switch today. And as always, receive City Suburban's POMG. That's peace of mind guarantee.
This is Chris from City Suburban on Route 233 in Westmoreland. There has never been a better time to upgrade your system than right now. You can save up to $9,000 with New York State clean heat rebates and make your home more comfortable and efficient for years to come. Call us today at 853-3899. That's 853-3899. Or visit us at citysuburban.com.
Mostly cloudy skies, 36 degrees. WIBX News time is 7:30. This news update is brought to you by My Carl's and the Lucky Triple Bonus Sale. With three bonuses to choose from, save on your sales tax, get a free area rug or free interest for one full year. My Carl's in the New Hartford Shopping Center and Destiny USA. America's biggest banks are coming to the rescue of First Republic Bank. 11 banks depositing a total of $30 billion into First Republic after depositors pulled billions out. The deal was put together by Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen, Fed Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell, and other financial brokers. At least two dozen Mar-a-Lago staff members have been subpoenaed to testify in the investigation of former President Trump's handling of classified documents. Reports indicate they range from servers to members of Trump's inner circle at the Florida property. Senator Marco Rubio says the U.S. should fly more drones over the Black Sea after Russian jets forced one out of the sky this week. Rubio said more drones should be deployed in the region, potentially alongside U.S. fighter jets that can respond to threats. The Florida Republican is the vice chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee. The majority of NCAA tournament brackets are busted. 15 seed Princeton pulled off a shocker 59-55 over number 2 seed Arizona. Also in the South, 13th seed Furman advanced after knocking off 4th seeded Virginia 68-67 with the buzzer beater. And the stage is set for today's New York City St. Patrick's Day Parade. Festivities kick off at 11 a.m. Eastern Time. Organizers say the best view goes to those who show up early. Spectators can start lining up on 5th Avenue as early as they like. WIBX News Time coming up on 7:33. I'm sorry. What's that, Smitty?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Go ahead. What is it?
Bill said if he wasn't back in the studio for you to get
caller the caller. Number four for the contest. Thank you so much.
How about caller 48?
No. Caller four. We have cloudy skies and 36 degrees. The rest of your forecast comes to you from Eyewitness News Chief Meteorologist Craig Flint.
From the WIBX Weather Center, I'm Eyewitness News meteorologist Craig Flint. Mainly light rain showers area-wide today. Light rain tapers to scattered showers, turning windy and colder late. High 46. Tonight, mainly cloudy sky, blustery, colder, a few snow flurries, a low near 30. I'm meteorologist Craig Flint on WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM.
Again, cloudy skies, 36 degrees. WIBX News time, 7:33. Time for our free money question of the day. It comes to you from the Hobica Law Firm. 724-1600. Do I have that right, Smitty? I've had to call it too many times to admit to. No, I'm kidding. 724-1600 from Andrew and Joseph Hobica. That's their number. But if you want to call for the contest, 315-736-0186. The free money question of the day, your chance to win $100 is up next. And then I promise up next after that, Katie Aiello, Utica Councilwoman, who is addressing some of the allegations made against her on the show earlier this week. Caller 4 right now, 315-736-0186.
I'm Martin Hoke, the inventor of Navage Nasal Care, and I love Navage. I've told you about how your nose is the body's air filter, that Navage's powered suction will help flush out allergens, viruses, mucus, and germs, and that Navage will help you breathe better. But what do other people say about Navage? Like Tara, quote, "My doctor wanted me to do saline rinses for my allergies, but I've never been able to successfully use a neti pot. Navage uses suction power, so it's foolproof. There are nights when I'll have particularly bothersome allergies. I'll bust it out, and the results are immediate. It's such a relief. It's become a lifesaver." Unquote. She's one of over 100,000 online reviews praising Navage, the all-natural solution trusted by over 3 million people to help you breathe better, sleep deeper, snore less, and stay healthier without drugs. Navage is available at Walmart, CVS, Walgreens, Target, Rite Aid, and online. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E, clean nose, healthy life.
Paid for by Altimetry Research.
Despite Joe Biden's age, raging inflation, and his dismal 45% approval level, one Pentagon consultant believes Biden could become one of the most powerful presidents in history. How is this all possible? Well, it's almost entirely because of a surprising July 25th twist that hardly anyone's talking about right now. A powerful new economic force is quietly building behind Joe Biden, and Biden can harness this force's inevitable wave, carrying him to a landslide re-election win. The good news is, this powerful new force can help you make a lot of money, even in a bear market. The bad news is, this July 25th twist is also likely to make Biden and the progressives more powerful than ever, meaning much bigger government, and it's going to be harder than ever to hold on to any money you make. After being asked to speak at the Pentagon recently in Washington, D.C., this insider put together an analysis of this situation, which details everything you need to know. You can access his full, brand new analysis free of charge by visiting BidenElection100.com. BidenElection100.com.
River Hills Properties remains the fastest growing real estate company in Central New York. This is Bill Keeler. When my wife and I decided we were selling our home, we chose River Hills Properties for several reasons. One of them, because the listing agent is there every time we show the house. That made all the difference in the world. The book, 30 to 100 pages filled with everything about the house, from the furnace, the warranties, everything was there. If you're looking to sell your home, contact Bill and Robin Mongeau at River Hills Properties. Nobody sells homes like River Hills. Bonneville, Utica, and Little Falls.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack, but not with ZipRecruiter. Its powerful technology actively finds and invites qualified candidates to apply to your job. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you the needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. Try ZipRecruiter for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
Okay, let's do our free money question of the day from the Hobica Law Firm, Joseph and Andrew Hobica. 315-724-1600. And Bill in Stittville is on the line here, ready to go. William, good morning. How are you?
Well, yourself?
Good, I'm doing okay.
Can I ask the question? For $100,
okay.
What Central New York municipality does Councilwoman Katie Aiello live in?
That's the million-dollar question.
That's a million-dollar question.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, Bill, here's your question. You'll ace it, I believe, and here we go. For $100, and 2 days in a row, we had a $100 winner yesterday. Here we go. According to legend, St. Patrick used this to explain the Holy Trinity to Irish pagans. What is this? Ready, go.
The shillelagh?
Is it the shillelagh?
I know this.
Manaski, according to legend, St. Patrick used this to explain the Holy Trinity.
The McDonald's Shamrock Shake.
It is the Shamrock, yeah.
It's the Shamrock.
Well, it was going to be the shillelagh or the shamrock, one or the other, I would assume. We will give you a table for six at Fat Cats Comedy Club. Michael Harrison is the headlining comedian this weekend, hilarious comic who's done really amazing things, especially online. Check out his podcast, Character Debates, an award-winning podcast out there. And the Utica All-in-One Food and Fun Card, $25 gift card to Aquavino, Babe, 72 Tavern and Grill. Taylor and the Cook, if you're going to see the Pioneers this weekend, you can use it at any of the concession stands at Adirondack Bank Center or at Nexus. And Davey's going to hook you up, Bill. And have a wonderful St. Patty's Day.
You too.
All right, thanks so much.
And that, by the way, the shamrock, not to be confused with the four-leaf clover.
Well, the three-leaf clover is the shamrock.
Right. And then right. the four-leaf clover.
The four-leaf is...
One's for God, one's for good luck.
What is the weirdest thing? And I'm going to tell you something. And Katie, this is something for you to think about, because maybe you'll have this talent, like my mom has. My mother can go to any lawn that hasn't been treated by, you know, she'll pull out the four-leaf clover.
Oh.
I mean, as kids, we would be searching and searching on the lawn. All I wanted to do was find the lucky four-leaf clover. And she could, 2 minutes, she'd have it pulled up. It's unbelievable. I don't know how she's able to do it, but she can find them.
Yeah, that's incredible.
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever found one. I thought it was a myth.
It is not a myth, yeah. I used to try to, like, pull one and stick them together and be like, look what I found, you know. But just trying to fit in. That's all I was trying to do. Katie Aiello, good morning. How are you? Things are good?
Yeah.
Your ears have been ringing, though.
A little bit.
Okay.
I worked on this transition for 2 days. Let me do it. From the comedian of character impressions to character coffee. There we go.
Here we go.
Perfect.
All right. What's going on? You had your opponent here yesterday and her fiance saying they've been interviewing people who claim that you do not or did not live in the city. Do you live within the city confines? Do you live in the city of Utica?
I absolutely do.
Okay.
This is just more intimidation, manipulation, lies. It's the strategy people use when they can't go off the issues. So, of course, I already was on air. I was saying how this was already investigated back in January. This properly goes through the county DA's office. A private investigator looks into everything. Russ is not a private.
Well, normally that's not a situation where the DA's office normally doesn't look into candidates and where they live.
Well, if you
unless
have
someone files a complaint,
if you have a problem with an elect, yes,
okay.
Exactly.
So, can I ask you? They said that you recently changed the lease because there's a minister or a priest.
Yes.
From, but he, apparently, and you have the document or a picture of it anyway.
Yes.
Where they say that the priest said you do not live there.
This goes back to Russ is out trying to prove his own conspiracy theories.
Right.
Even though the DA already closed it, so now they'll look at it again. This paper, I don't even know. First of all, they love that it's a priest. This is part of their manipulation of trying to spin it, because then they want to also manipulate the public. Like, they manipulated my landlord into signing this. I've rented there since June 2021.
How do they manipulate your – you've rented there.
I live there, too.
This is my apartment. Do you sleep there every night?
Yes.
Okay. Now that we want to know where
you're also. So the other part, though, he wants to talk about is this Herkimer connection. That's my parents' house. This is their property. I don't own it. I have nothing in my name. That's why you can't find anything. Probably why he's the same person who also tried to foil my children's school for information about my residency.
Right.
Which I doubt he got what he wanted then, because it doesn't say I live in Herkimer. Then this goes. So whatever this lease
is. Do your kids go to school in Utica?
No, they don't.
They don't.
No.
Okay.
And so just going back to, when I was talking to my landlord, he tells me that Russ Pelley tried calling him 10 times a day for a week. Morella's sitting there crying to him, saying, you need to sign this. The English isn't
Morella,
easy with
those,
my
those
actual opponent.
Morella is the opponent, and Russ is the fiance of the opponent. Now, they're claiming that they have absolute proof that you don't live in the district. Now, where this probably comes from is in the beginning, there was a time where your residence was an unoccupied building.
Yeah.
And you didn't really live there.
Right. And I never said I did.
Okay.
That's what he's also trying. We have so many lies to try to correct.
Did you spend one night there to make it legitimate?
No, it wasn't even to make it legitimate. It was genuinely trying to work and fix up the place to live there. And
but only one night you spent there.
I think it was one night. Yeah, and then same thing Maria did. This is what's fascinating. This is the strategy. We saw it with Frank Facera. We saw it happen to Maria McNeil. I used her own case law against her in court when she did it to me. Based on where you intend to live, that was why that address
was. So that was brought up, so if we can catch up, because a lot of things you're bringing up here. That was, she questioned the legitimacy of your residency. And a court ruled against you.
We were blown away by that. Yes.
Right. However, though, what I've been told is that the higher court, you appealed, and the higher court ruled in your favor.
Yes.
But they say that it was by default because her attorney didn't show up to the proceedings, so it was like a 3-1 decision or You go to the appellate court for that?
Right. So what happened, the first judge, who I had the same judge as Maria had when it was against her, and he ruled in favor of her. It comes to me. And he even says, I believe Katie did nothing fraudulent. She had positive intent of moving in here. He personally just didn't think the building would be left standing. And that's what this whole court case was about, mm-hmm. of if a judge gets to rule on
it. Was it in the building that is the, was Brett Truitt's building?
Yes.
Okay.
The pink door.
Which is gone
and
now,
then
right?
They're all excited about this email from Sue Arcuri, of all people, who was messaging Brett Truitt at the time. Brett Truitt just sends me the message and says, hey, she wants to know about the building. I said, don't tell this woman anything about me. Keep me out of it. So then they use that evidence in court.
Now, Sue Arcuri was a former congressman. No, that was Mike Arcuri. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I'm sorry. She's no one,
She's no one.
She has a blog, and she attacks people.
But they're excited. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But they're excited by this. So then, we appeal it. There's five judges in Rochester. They all agree with us. It's actually, I think, the ruling was embarrassing from the first one. Then we do appeal the appeal. I think he actually showed up. Maybe he didn't hand something
I've
in.
I've heard from three different people, one who I would trust in this case who's involved in politics, says that her attorney and she did not show up for for that, and they ruled. But you don't really have to show up.
It was such a slam dunk case. Okay. Why didn't they show up? So
well, there was one. Apparently, there was one of the jurors who voted, the judges who voted against you.
No, we had a unanimous.
It was unanimous?
It was all seven.
Okay.
All right. So at this point, there's 12 judges, and it goes through that. So that was really fascinating because that's the game. Kick people off the ballot before they can even run. Make them go broke.
Well, it is a strategy that some will use, and sometimes they're successful. Knocking someone off the ballot. So
now here we are.
So you currently do live.
This is my home.
This is your home.
You can call me.
I don't need to. Yeah, I'm just asking you.
No, it is. And I think I get mad because this is so pointless. This is nothing what my voters actually care about. And that's where I thought I was coming on to talk about the Mandeville fire today.
Well, we'll talk about that. But you do know you had to expect we were going to talk about
this. Oh, totally.
This.
I'm grateful to be able to fill in the blanks of.
So, all right, and you've lived there all along, right? I mean, I feel like we're beating a dead horse here, but I just feel like there's when was the last time you spoke to the DA's office about this? Because I feel like they're a neutral, uninvolved party, right? They're investigating it. It's not like he said, she said, no, my landlord said, right?
I was speaking with them last week. It's funny, even the end of February, I think it was, I actually called. I've had people coming up to my door, knocking on it, saying, do you live there? I'm over it. I actually called the county DA's office, the private investigator, before I knew any of this stuff was happening with Pelley, and said, hey, I'm thinking about actually moving. Do I have to go through you? Should I give you a heads up? They said, no, that's not. If you do move, I'm sure let us know because it'll probably be an issue.
But you're moving inside your district.
Of course.
Yeah. Okay.
And if I did. And that's where, you know, I call my landlord, and then I said, can I have a copy of the lease? And that's that day I find out. He's like, I just signed something for these people. I don't know what it is. And
did you make him do the lease over? Did you ask for him to rewrite the lease so your name was on it or something?
No, my name's
that?
Been on it since June 2021. I just didn't have a copy of it.
Okay.
So this is why I call my landlord to find out, is it month to month? Do I actually, what happens if I have to leave? Mm-hmm. Then we go through that. And
how many in the apartment? Is it an apartment building?
Yeah.
How many tenants live there?
There's just an upstairs and us.
Okay,
yeah.
so
that's
now they say the priest said. Can you explain the priest thing? Because what Russ Pally said is the priest said no, she does not live here.
And then
about that.
Don't know. There's so many things to refute that Russ Pally says.
Yes,
who's not my opponent. I would love to hear my actual opponent come on sometime. But
She was on yesterday.
I did not hear her on the phone, but that's great. Says I don't live there. I don't know. I told my landlord, I'm like, if that's what was said, then I want all my money back. And he's like, no, that's not the case. I see him sometimes. Sometimes I don't.
Mm-hmm.
If I don't live there, how was I out there for the Mandeville fire that was the block behind me the whole night? You see Bobby Sullivan. Everybody's there. They all live on Cottage Place.
Right.
There's people actually from the building who were displaced. One of them recognized me, not because I'm a councilwoman, but they saw me at Palermo's. She asked for a blanket or something.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in the community. I'm here.
Yeah.
This is just the next step, I guess.
So. All right.
The Mandeville Street Fire. There's a bigger issue going on than people being displaced. It looks like a couple dozen people living in what was an abandoned house.
Yes.
What do I have right there?
Can I just clarify? You weren't one of them living in that building.
No. But also, I do want to say
that would be in the district, though.
I don't just live here. I wanted to add one thing. I don't just live here because I'm on the council. I lived for 3 years on Sherman Place. I lived for 3 years on Lansing Street. I did 2 years. I was at the Westwood. Utica's home.
Right.
So that's, I think, another part where he says, I do not, never have. I'm like, okay. See you out there. Anyway, go on. Mandeville. It matters.
No, I just, it's funny that I feel like this, I shouldn't tell you, I'm sure you don't think it's funny, but it's like, so the Mandeville Street Fire, yes. What is your take on it? How do we address that situation over there?
It's alarming. It's, first of all, I want to thank the fire department who was there all night, the police department. You had Pastor Ballman from the Morrow Center who showed up and stepped up in a lot of ways. ICANN, DSS, Rescue Mission, and Red Cross. A lot of people came together for that community. But yeah, that night, it turns out there were 20 to 30 people who were staying in there. And I think this goes back to a bigger concern I have of the shelter options that are in the city and in the county, rather. That's where we have the Rescue Mission. It's so important. They offer so many services. They do so much. But then we hear, you know, not everybody's comfortable going there for whatever the reasons are.
Well, they have rules. And you can't go there if you're under the influence of drugs or alcohol. You can't go in at night.
Correct.
So they I believe, turn people away. If
there are rules. At the same time, I've done a couple tours with the Rescue Mission. And this is what was interesting to me. Wendy was explaining that, yes, they have drug tests, but that doesn't mean you have to pass it. We just need to know if you're going to overdose and to keep an eye on you, depending on which facility they're in. Some people are afraid.
So they don't turn people away if they're on drugs?
It depends which category that they're taking people in. Sometimes they do. I also want to say it's not always just about not wanting to follow the rules. There's a big part of my story where I got to learn about the Rescue Mission firsthand. I used to be married, and he was in the Army, got hurt on one of his drill trainings, has a hernia, has to go through a hernia surgery. Tell you all this to say they prescribe him every pain med you can imagine.
Mm-hmm.
Turns into an awful addiction. Our lives change forever. And from there, all of a sudden, I know what ASC is, the Addiction Stability Center. You're in those waiting rooms. You experience it all. You're at the mercy of, even if they finally go to rehab, sometimes 2 weeks in, insurance says, that's enough. You're good.
Mm-hmm.
They're not good. But insurance doesn't want to keep paying.
Right,
so it creates
these
cycles. So one of the reasons I remember my ex-husband at the time, he's sober now, thank God, amazing dad. That's not everybody's story, but this,
we
were grateful for this. So then one of the times he didn't want to go to Rescue Mission, it's because other people were there in circles that he was trying to be away from. And it wasn't because he wasn't trying to follow rules or something, but one option. In fact, even the Rescue Mission doesn't have a one-size-fits-all option. They have the shelter, the residential programs, the enriched living, all that, ASC, the actual drop-in centers. So, but one option in a city of low barrier shelter, well, first of all, it's not shelter, isn't enough for an entire county of 230,000 people. And also, why, when we have 28% of the population in Utica, why are 100% of the services in Utica out of the whole county? That's what I'm trying to say.
Right. By the way, Katie Aiello running for
City Council.
City Council. In a heated primary.
Yep.
That's true, right? I mean,
it is. Yeah.
It's turned into a bit of a nightmare, I guess.
A little bit. I think that's what happened. Yeah.
So, so what is the solution? What is the you're saying there's a problem.
There is a problem. And we're going to keep having a problem. That house that happened on Mandeville, that's not unique. There's more houses on Mandeville that are actually vacant. I keep saying if we don't provide low barrier shelter, they're going to keep creating their own. We're going to keep having these problems.
Low barrier shelter.
Yes.
Explain what that
technically
means. You can be
high. You can be drunk. You can go there and get the help you need. You can't harass other people. There's other. This is why we see you can keep your own possessions with you. That's a big thing that people have a hard time with if they go into these.
They give up their possessions when they go into the into the Rescue Mission.
Which I understand. There's a place like there's spaces for those rules, and then there's spaces where these people. I also wanted to add one of the things that helped me. You know, we see all these stigmas with people in addiction and fighting this. I took me so long to get out of this part of my marriage at its worst. I would have done it so much sooner had I known there was a place he could go with a roof over his head. And I think for the families to be able to get their life back on track and not to have my daughters be raising this at that time, you have to break those generational cycles. I just wasn't ready to do that until there was an option. And at one day, I just had to say, no, enough is enough.
Yeah.
And it's terrifying. But mm-hmm. if we want to actually help the families too, yes, not everybody's ready to get help. But eventually, you go through your cycles, and we right. see a lot of progress from that.
Right.
So Mandeville, they're going to keep making their own shelters. And
so this is the issue of the low barrier shelter. I think Celeste touched on this earlier this week as well. What you're saying is... in some cases, if people choose not to go to the mission, essentially is what they make their own low barrier shelter.
Mm-hmm.
They just break into what like a home that had been damaged by fire before, or that's abandoned, nobody's living in it. And then you have, you know, 6, 8, 10, 25 people living in a two-family
especially
house.
Especially in the wintertime.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that's where I believe all the space heaters.
Where the fire probably came from was a space heater, mm-hmm. or in some cases they'll start a fire to just get some heat. And it ends up catching the entire building on fire. You want to add something?
Yeah, well, we look at the cost of these shelters. You know, there are stigmas around it, mental mm-hmm. health and addiction. But the cost of these firefighters, you know, you heard Chief Ingersoll this past week share that they are crawling through the Mandeville property. There's needles everywhere. And it's not even safe for the canine unit to go in. Like, mm-hmm. an actual dog's not going in. But we're right. sending our men and firefighters in to... explore this building, trying to find the cause and all of
yeah.
this. If one of them gets stabbed or something with a dirty needle, let alone the cost of their life,
sure.
What are the actual costs of the health care involved with this? And if somebody sued, this is millions when we could be proactive and put it ahead of just putting roofs over people's heads until they can get the help they need.
So who's responsible for that? Who does that? The city, the county?
It's an interesting thing. So we have city, you know, a lot of housing is a city issue, mm-hmm. but then we have this mental health and addiction services, public health, that is a county issue. So there's kind of two issues and solutions. So I think, you know, I actually have to get back to our county executive, Anthony Picente. He was great, replied to me immediately because I want to discuss more. What are the options that they are thinking
of? He'll
be
in next hour, by the way.
Oh, nice. Yep. And yeah, we need a navigation center. The city's very strongly believes in that. One of the things that frustrated me that night is, yes, the rescue, Red Cross did come. They were only directed to support the tenants. They got comfort care kits for everybody else. They are always willing to go above and beyond
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
But it came down to Pastor Ballman from the Morrow Center and his small team who wasn't even ready to take people in. But why do we have like this volunteer crew calling DSS and ICANN and pulling the weight on this? So there's something in the system I want to see if we can make sure it doesn't happen this way again.
Yeah, okay. On the whole issue of your candidacy running for council, mm-hmm. what do you want to say at this point to the voters? They've heard a lot of stuff.
I would
imagine that many of the voters are confused. They're hearing accusations made from your opponent. They've seen, for some reason, the Democratic Party has mm-hmm. has endorsed your opponent. What do you want to say to voters?
I haven't been on since the last time I made for. So if you go to katieforutica.com, if you click the menu bar, I have a whole Pecmez Pelly timeline. You can read through everything. It has screenshots and receipts attached for everything. It's about, I feel like, 60 columns long. Read it for yourself. I will always provide the details of that information.
And you say the executive committee knew about the bribe, or
there are people on there who did know about it.
Okay.
Yes. And that's part of this. I knew it wasn't going to be easy.
Who on the committee knew?
A couple people. I shared with our Frank Miola that year. I believe Maria is saying that she doesn't know that I told her. She's on the executive committee meeting. I told everybody. Bill, that's where it's like, it was pretty mind-blowing to me that it happened.
So I've had people say to me they did not know.
Right.
Who were on the committee,
sure.
that they were unaware.
Well, here's the question. They know now. Is it right or wrong to give an elected official money while you're also asking for money? If Bowers Development, Pesanella, gave the mayor an envelope of cash, would we be uncomfortable with that? I would be.
Yeah.
And that's where I'm, even whether or not they knew before, we know now. So what is?
I guess the next part that I would say, though, is you really waited to share it. Why wouldn't you have gone to the DA's office a year ago when that happened?
I actually did. I reported it.
And you did report to the DA's office?
No, I reported to our own police.
Okay.
And then within a few months of, well, I reported it to the DA's even before the election really picked up. And a lot of people I reported it to. So that was the formal process of that.
So you did speak with the police department, Utica PD,
mm-hmm.
and you did speak with the DA's office.
Yes.
Who at the DA's office did you speak with?
The private investigator actually assigned to my case back
okay.
in January.
All right.
So, and just to put it out there, and I don't know, you know, there's a lot of stipulations when it comes to actual bribery of either I would have to provide something to show proof.
Right.
And that's kind of where I knew it wasn't going to be easy to talk about. I wanted to shed light on the process for a lot of reasons. And I figured there'd be some retaliation. So that's why I'm not surprised that they're going to keep throwing out. It's another thing Pelly kept saying yesterday, that I was on the council for 4 years. No, I've been on the council for 1 year, 2.5 months. I'm running for re-election. There's more to do.
Mm-hmm.
I've ran before. I ran in 2019. I ran in 2021 against a fantastic opponent, Paul DePietro, the kindest person I could ask for,
yeah.
who ran a clean, fair race. He didn't care. I lived at Cottage Place.
During the time that you've been sworn in and up until now, you have always lived within the district.
Yes. This has always been, I have no other property in my name. I have nothing else attached to me. And even if I wasn't on the council, like I said, I'd still be here.
And your point also is that it's been reported to the DA's office. They have investigated. And you have been cleared of your residency issue.
Yeah, that was back in January. So,
okay.
of course, this opened a new thing, but that's...
So you're saying they're looking at it again? They've told you they're looking into it again?
I think they're just, like, saying, what is this? And double-checking that, which is fair. I'm for it with all of that. So I want people to know I'm in the district. If there's a fire happening in our backyard... I'm going to be there.
Right, right.
And that's what, and voters know that. When I'm going door to door, this isn't the stuff they're asking about. They're talking about codes.
Mm-hmm.
They want to know what the process is. If the building next door to them doesn't have siding on it and they say, why isn't codes doing anything? Well, there's a process. You have to cite them and then it takes 30 days and then goes through the court system. And that's the stuff that they care about.
Yeah.
We have feral cats. We have lots of other issues. So anybody who has questions, I'm always here to answer them, but I really want to stop talking about a guy from East Utica who lives on the Parkway, who's not even my opponent, and just address the issues with actual constituents.
Well, and as I said, that he did call in yesterday, but your opponent did call in afterwards and echoed the same things. It seems like they have, and I'll ask you to respond to this, it seems like they have conducted their own investigation. They're out interviewing people. They're knocking on doors. Mm-hmm. They're interviewing the priests. They're getting signed pieces of paper that they're saying are affidavits. What is your response to those efforts that they're putting?
I'm not surprised. If you don't have the own issues to go off of, you're going to try and prove something to, you know, I told the world, he brings me in an envelope of cash. It looks like an attempted bribe to me. Of course, this is the next step, like I said. It doesn't matter. He can keep doing that. They both can. I'm over it.
Yeah.
I'm so over it. People have questions. They know where to find me. It's the other thing. I don't see them involved at our community meetings. It's funny to see them involved in all of these other aspects of my life. Every little detail they are trying to find out about me. But I don't see them at a common council meeting.
I'm assuming the being a common council member pays what, $200,000-$300,000 a year?
Yeah, exactly.
It does seem like this is a really sought after position.
That's what I think concerns me is why want it this bad if you're not actually invested in? And a lot of this was, you know, they wanted ARPA funding. When that didn't happen, we saw the Morella when she actually read her piece to the entire committee to be screened. Her only concrete proposal was to have a community center, which is what they asked me for a year from our ARPA money.
Mm-hmm.
So it's...
And at the end of the day, though, your Democratic Party, your committee, has endorsed her for your position,
mm-hmm.
which is certainly unique. You normally don't see that happen.
No.
So, all right. We'll do this again. I appreciate you.
I really appreciate this, too. Again,
I'm
always here to talk, and that's what I always wanted from my actual representative for years. Go on the radio. Be with the people.
Right.
That's what we're doing. So thank you.
Well, we appreciate it. Katie Aiello, thank you. WIBX Utica Rome. We'll break and come right back.
803.
Adirondack Home Furniture now carries Smith Brothers Furniture. Smith Brothers has been creating customized living room furniture since 1925 and is known for its high quality, solid built, top of the line pieces. Made in America with modern technology using age old craftsmanship. Smith Brothers offers furniture that you can have confidence in for generations. Smith Brothers is a solid and dependable brand who provide innovative furniture design with every piece. Smith Brothers is a leader in the furniture industry with their award winning line of upholstered furniture. They have built a reputation for their value and design leadership with furniture of the finest quality. We would love for you to come and browse our extensive inventory and see for yourself. Smith Brothers, now available at Adirondack Home Furniture. Stop in today. Adirondack Home Furniture in the Riverside Center, North Utica, or at AdirondackHomeFurniture.com. Create the home of your dreams with Smith Brothers and Adirondack Home Furniture. 315-738-7817.
You wash your hands, you brush your teeth, but how do you clean your nose? With Navage. Navage uses powered suction to pull saline in one nostril, around the back of the nose, and out the other nostril, flushing out allergens, mucus, and germs. And it's why cleaning your nose, the body's air filter, is the next evolution in daily personal hygiene. Navage helps you breathe better, sleep deeper, and snore less, but the biggest payoff is improved health. At Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Target, and online. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E. Clean nose, healthy life.
Hi, I'm Joe Carbone. Welcome to Harley-Davidson of Utica. Get a jump on your riding season with over 120 Harley-Davidson motorcycles to choose from. Harley-Davidson Motor Company 120th anniversary celebration is March 25th. Stop in for food, beverages, music, and lots of Harley-Davidson giveaways. Register to win a 2023 breakout and a free trip to Milwaukee for the anniversary blowout. So come to Harley-Davidson of Utica March 25th for our great event.
Are you ready to make the most important decision for your child's future? Some are easy, some are not. Some make all the difference, like choosing Notre Dame schools. Offering grades pre-K through 12, your child will be ready to learn and thrive in a challenging atmosphere surrounded by great teachers and the most current technology. Notre Dame offers small class sizes, high academic standards, and spiritual fulfillment. At Notre Dame, we foster an environment of diversity and community. Students feel supported and more confident in achieving their goals. Our students learn from each other and are challenged to grow and develop their innate talents. Notre Dame is faith-based, but everyone is welcome. If you have higher expectations for your child, Notre Dame offers a higher level experience. If you're ready to launch your child's future into the most successful career path and build the next generation of leaders, call today for a tour or visit NotreDameUtica.org. Notre Dame schools, ready to learn, destined to lead.
It's March, and you know what that means? Taxes are almost due. Jackson Hewitt can help you win tax season. That's the sound of your maximum tax refund. The sound of getting 50% off tax prep. The sound of many of our competitors' prices going up. And the sound of getting to your nearest Jackson Hewitt. Hurry in for 50% off tax prep before this offer expires April 9th. Limited time offer for new clients filing at participating locations. Max value $200. Visit jacksonhewitt.com/50 for terms.
I always wanted to learn Spanish, but I never thought I'd have the time. Then I discovered Babbel.
Babbel's lessons are fun. They only take like 10 or 15 minutes, and in 3 weeks, presto, you're starting to speak another language. Like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right. And they're designed by real language teachers, so you learn how to have real-world conversations, things you'll actually use.
It's incredible. After using Babbel, I'm ready to start having real conversations in French.
There's all kinds of ways to learn. Use Babbel's podcasts or games or videos. You can even join live classes with a language teacher.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
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 Babbel. Évidemment.
Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's Babbel.com. Babbel.com.
Our locally owned and operated small businesses are the heartbeat of our community. The WYBX 950 and 106.9 FM industry aces stand out as leaders in their fields, like Clinton Car Wash, caring for your ride with hometown pride in Clinton. At Clinton Car Wash, they are now offering unlimited plans starting at $19.99 a month. And with an unlimited membership, you can wash your car every day. Support one of these fantastic WYBX industry aces here in Central New York today.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
Hey, Collis, Spread Up Collis & Sons Heating and Cooling and Insulation. If you're looking to make sure your home is warmer for the rest of this winter, but even more than that, I think it's important to make sure your house is completely insulated and buttoned up perfectly for the summertime to keep it cooler. Collis can help. They've been doing insulation for years, and they would love to assist you with your heating, cooling, and insulation needs. A whole team dedicated to ensuring their customers save in any way possible. And New York has many rebates and incentives out there, and they can get you connected to those. And in some cases, people have had their entire project completely paid for using rebates and incentives. It's amazing. The process begins with a free home energy assessment, something that we had done at our home, and then you continue through the process, and Collis walks you through it all. If you're thinking about heating, cooling, and maybe finding that your energy bills are just a bit too high, contact Fred F. Collis Heating, Cooling, and Insulation today. Manaske, we just heard from Katie Aiello. What are your thoughts?
Well,
on
I
this?
Don't know.
Where do you live is my question.
Yeah, I was just going to ask the comedian that as well. And he walked here.
By the way, to all the listeners, I didn't even listen to what just happened. I was in the green room on Tinder. I was just swiping right.
You're better off. You're better off.
I don't know. All I know is I just came back into the studio and the energy's way different in here.
It's different.
I don't know if I can save the show anymore.
You can cut it with a knife. You can cut it with a knife in here.
Yeah. All right. Good. All right.
Yeah.
So tell me about it, guys. All right. What happened?
What do you think?
To be honest with you, I don't know. We talked to Russ and Morella yesterday, and I'm like, okay, well, they make a pretty good case, and they send me this form signed by the landlord, who's a priest.
Can we say that we just heard audio of...
From her phone with
from
the landlord.
Her, and she said it was the landlord, who she says, and you can hear the guy saying, who's apparently a man of God, a priest. I believe he's a priest.
Okay.
And he's saying that...
I don't know. They stopped by 10 times.
10 times. She's crying. She says, I have to sign this paper. So I signed the paper, and now I'm in the middle of it.
So what? I don't know. And then we talked to Katie, and I'm like, oh, okay. Well, then there's your defense right there.
So
it's like this back and forth. I don't know.
If Katie says she lives here, then you got to trust that she lives here. However, I'd love to talk to the priest. I'd love to talk to the DA's office. We should confirm with the DA's office
Indeed,
they did have a conversation. They've investigated, and they also investigated the potential bribe. There's a bribe involved.
Wow.
This is you say you're up here, things are quieter up here. This is like New York City Council crap happening up here.
Yeah, Utica, taboo.
Taboo. Hey? You're right. Jeez. You're right. Yeah. And then who else? Then the committee knew. People on the committee knew. But I've spoken to committee members who say they didn't know about the money. And, you know, we call it a bribe. Pelly says, listen, let's be honest, though. You're looking to get funding from, and it's your council person, and you want funding for your project. You all of a sudden drop an envelope off, and there's $500 in cash in it, and you say, no, pay it forward. I mean, what does it look like? It looks like it's maybe a contribution, not a bribe, a contribution. But what is the difference between a bribe and a contribution? So when people make a political contribution to a politician, mm-hmm. aren't they usually doing it to be saying, you know, I do it because if I need help, I want to know that I have this politician's ear.
Yeah,
that's why
cause.
They're really doing it. It's a write-off, yes, but you're doing it to help the community and your own cause. How is that any different than a... You know, I guess you're not giving the contribution usually in an envelope with $500 bills.
You sound very pro-bribe right now.
I'm big into bribery.
Yeah, very pro-bribe.
Well, listen, I mean, how do you think we do the topics? We choose what we talk about every morning based on the money that flows into the studio.
As I've always said.
I'm going to push a 20 over there if you keep saying character debates a few more times before I get off.
You let us know what you want.
Always, man. News tips taken here.
Exactly.
obviously, that's not true at all. But Davey's brought... A five won't do it. A five won't do it, Davey. I'm sorry. Not even on your birthday. Yeah.
So, I don't know.
So, we'll continue to look into it a little bit. But if all of what she says is true, And then she's added the part where she was in the midst of an addiction case with her ex-husband.
Yeah, that caught me off guard. I didn't know that. I didn't know that's where the interview was going.
Terrible world that people live in today. And the fact that she's been trying to assist him, and she speaks very highly of him and says he's been able to become clean and he's a great dad. She has kids in the mix here, and it makes things much more personal and difficult. So if all of what she says is
true. By the way, this all sounds like a great movie.
It does.
I really want to see this.
It would be on, which channel would it be on? It would be on Lifetime.
Hallmark. Yeah.
Hallmark. Lifetime?
Ooh.
Davey. Hallmark! I hate that channel.
Why didn't he just bribe her with fat cats?
It could have been.
This is a good weekend.
Table for six, table for ten. But if what she says is true, I feel very bad for her if what she says is completely true.
Right. Right. No, I agree. So I'm going to reach out to the district attorney's office. I hope to report back on Monday.
All right. I like it.
With a full report on, first of all, did they investigate the residency issue? What was the determination? And then did she reach out regarding the cash envelope full of cash, not the cash full of envelope that happened over a year ago?
In studio is Michael Harrison. He is a headlining comedian tonight and tomorrow night at Fat Cats Comedy Club.
I've bribed no one for this gig.
He is lying.
I was going to say, speaking of district attorney investigations.
Yeah. No priest was involved in the booking of this gig, I promise. Yeah, I don't care what anyone says.
We have, technically, we bribe you. I mean, we pay you. Why else would you come upstate, right? We basically pay you.
You have to bribe me to get
to
Utica.
So I'm completely intrigued by the podcast character debate.
Yeah, it's the best.
So if you were to explain how it's done. I'm going to be listening to this later today.
Sweet.
Explain how it's done, and then Manasky and I will play. Do you moderate it?
Yeah, I moderate it.
Okay. So you give us each a character, and we'll see what we can do.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, really?
I love the caveman thing.
Okay. Oh.
But we couldn't do that.
So, okay, like an upcoming one would, I think we're going to have Leonardo DiCaprio on.
Okay, well, yeah, I can't be him.
No, that's not you. All right,
so you have comics who are doing
your wife's 10 years younger than you.
Doing full.
His would be 35 years younger than him, but there's an age difference.
They do full impressions.
Yeah. So full impressions, and then he's going to be debating a gentleman on should men date women half their age.
A guy who. And the topic is, should men date women
half their age? So that'll be coming up, because Leonardo DiCaprio's only dated women 25 and younger.
That is kind of true, right?
So we're going to have a debate if that's that. And the gentleman only dated a woman within the hour of his birth. So he's completely against it.
That's right.
And that would be like...
How do you narrow that down? I mean, that's got to be... I mean, he's it's been very difficult for him to be able to be... Like, you know, here we are grilling Katie Aiello this morning. You'd have to grill every potential date. It's like, I want to know the time you were born.
Exactly.
It's got to be within the hour.
What day? Give me those hospital records. That's my dating field.
And you use comics from around the country on this. And
New York City. So it's like seller comics. So a lot of big ones we've had, right? Mike Kaplan. We Judy Gold's coming up.
Wow, that's awesome.
I know. Sean Patton, who just had a special on Peacock. So... Yeah, we're doing really well. So, yeah, like I say, we did Just for Laughs, which is the world's biggest comedy fest.
Yeah.
We're pitching as a TV show right now, and we're in talks with for our own special, but we'll see how that goes.
You hope it happens.
That's awesome.
Too.
Do you do any impressions?
Me? No. I'm the moderator. I created the thing.
You know
what's weird about impressions nowadays? Is like back in the day, like all those actors and everything, like Nicholson and Pacino, they're so charactery. So they had such a definite voice that you could impersonate. But now, it's
a very
tough.
Good point.
Yeah.
It is tough. Matt Damon sounds like every Joe. So does Ben Affleck. So does DiCaprio. Like, you're really squeezing. You're probably trying to do one of their roles if you're going to try to impersonate
but
them.
But the roles they're playing, the big roles, you're right, are not... You know, they're not those mob type roles
like
De Niro, like Joe Pesci or De Niro. I mean, those guys you could do an impression of, and
of course, because it's simple. They have cadence.
Yeah, that was terrible. But even Brando had his own style.
Even Johnny Carson had his thing. But you look at a lot of the people today; everything's blasé. It's like you wouldn't know they're doing an impression of that person. I thought Biden was going to be tough. But there is a guy out there that does a done an unbelievable Biden.
Biden actually is tough.
He is tough.
Like, yeah, it's another thing.
Trump's easy. Everybody's doing Trump.
Yeah, Trump although, is easy. Trump's such a character, right? That's
although,
another one.
DeBono, who is a comic we're going to have coming up.
He's a buddy of mine.
In April. I was on his podcast on Sunday night.
Hilarious. Yay. Okay, good.
Really.
Yeah,
so it's a bunch of comics that get together and talk. And yeah. Mine was from a standpoint of the club and radio. But it's his. What I love about it, his impression is spot on. The key to him is he's funny, and the content is the jokes are funny.
Yeah,
there are so many people who can get the impression down, but then they don't know what to say, and it's not funny.
Yeah.
So it's great. You get all wowed by the great impression, and then about a minute in, the stuff isn't funny, and it's not
even. I mean,
yeah. But DeBono is spot on and hilarious.
Did he?
But you're right. The new actors and, you know, you. How would you know who you're doing? John Wayne.
Right.
Everybody knows. Everybody can do John Wayne.
Who? No, just kidding.
But today there aren't those characters.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, so weird. I was really jacked. Yeah, the guy who's coming into DiCaprio, he's like really working on one. But yeah, it sounds like a regular guy, except he knows that DiCaprio elongates certain words.
Yeah.
So it's like, but other than that, it's not very,
right.
like,
yeah.
You know, it's tough nowadays, I think, for impressionists to nail someone, because you're right, everyone's just so average Joe.
It's like you, with DiCaprio, you'd have to do, like, what was his line in Titanic? I'm king of the world. Oh, you're doing DiCaprio.
Yeah.
Right? Right? Otherwise, you wouldn't know.
I don't know. It sounded like Bill Keeler.
It does a little bit.
That was. Yeah. It's like, didn't you say that yesterday's episode?
I say it all the time.
I'm king of the world.
King of the world.
You introduced yourself to me that way.
The thing I say in the bedroom.
Hello, I'm Michael Harrison. Hi, I'm king of the world. Oh, wow. What's your name? Bill? Okay.
Michael Harrison is at Fat Cats Comedy Club. And Davey, let's do one more. First caller through. We'll give him tickets to one of the shows this weekend. You can go for details at fatcatscomedyclub.com and purchase your tickets right there. I do have to break. We'll come right back. It's 8:21. County Executive Anthony Picente coming up in a few minutes. And Michael Harrison is in studio.
Sweet. Hi, I'm Max Carbone, sales manager at Power Sports Utica. We are currently overstocked on 2023 Ski-Doo models, and we are offering up to $2,000 off sticker plus a $500 gift card for anything in the store. Kawasaki KLR models have $1,000 in rebates as well, and we have all colors and trims available in stock and ready for delivery. Kawasaki KLX models have $400 in rebate and up to $1,500 off KX models. Come visit us at Power Sports Utica, Central New York's Four Seasons Toy Store.
For your financial advice to be useful, it needs to be tailored to how you live your life. I'm Jim McGuire, branch manager of Baird's Utica office. At Baird, we provide investment and financial planning for all areas of your life, retirement, family, and estate plans, and charitable giving. Plus, we coordinate our advice with your tax and legal advisors, so you can be confident all your plans are working together for you. Discover the Baird difference. Visit BairdUtica.com.
I can't take this kitchen any longer. Carl, we need to start looking for a new house.
Honey, you know the housing market is tight. It's going to be next to impossible to find something that we like.
I know, but this kitchen has to go.
Hey, what about a home equity loan from Adirondack Bank? We can turn the equity from our home into cash to renovate, just the way you want.
Renovate?
Adirondack Bank has competitive rates, and they've been a trusted community bank for decades.
A new kitchen. Wouldn't that be awesome?
Yeah.
Then, of course, we would need new furniture. Well, and we could repair the deck,
what?
Even add a pool, and take that trip to Italy that we've always talked about.
Whoa, slow down, honey. Let's go talk to the experts at Adirondack Bank about that home equity loan. Then we can decide where to start.
I've always wanted to add on a craft room.
Ugh.
And our bathroom needs a facelift.
Don't move. Improve. Stop into your local Adirondack Bank branch for more information on a home equity loan.
Or visit AdirondackBank.com.
Bank local with Adirondack Bank, your hometown community bank.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Poor Sam was a mess. Always itching, licking. His paws were soaking wet. He had bald spots on his back.
DINOVITE.com.
2 weeks after he started Dynavite, I started seeing great improvements, and today 99% of his issues are non-existent.
Dynavite is nutrition.
Dynavite is the best thing you can do for your dog.
You won't believe how happy your dog will be.
I get my Dynavite from DINOVITE.com.
Do you ever get the feeling that the world is being held together with duct tape?
Every day we're thrown some new meaningless drama in the fake news to distract us from the reality we're all about to face. Between the government trying to print their way out of debt, military conflicts, the disintegration of our most trusted institutions, and a looming food shortage, preparedness is no longer a choice. It's a necessity. You can trust My Patriot Supply. Our emergency food kits come packed with tasty meals, averaging over 2,000 calories per day. Get at least one kit for each person in your family. Self-reliance is the only alternative to government food lines. Time is running out. Become ungovernable. Go to MyPatriotSupply.com and save on dozens of different emergency food kits while you can. These kits are in stock, ship fast, and arrive in unmarked boxes for your privacy. Go to MyPatriotSupply.com before the next crisis strikes. MyPatriotSupply.com.
Hey, I'll tell you, Ricky Z is all excited about every time you're driving down the road, you see another Mazda and more Mazdas. These are award-winning vehicles that are, it's a hot brand right now. And it's a solid vehicle, manufactured beautifully, and the new 2023s are beautiful. Mazda CX-30s, CX-5s, and CX-50s. On the lot, I have the CX-9 that I leased. You right now can enjoy 0%. That's 0.9% APR financing up to 36 months. It's their Move to Mazda sales event, and it is back. Now, Rick's way of dealing with people when they walk through the door, it's a completely different buying experience, which is why they've achieved first place nationally. That is, of all the Mazda dealerships in the United States, Steeponey Mazda on Commercial Drive in Yorkville is number one for customer satisfaction. That's a big deal. It's Steeponey Mazda, Commercial Drive in Yorkville, as Ricky says. Just come in. We'll make your deal on a brand new or pre-owned Mazda.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
And the official coffee of the Keeler in the Morning program is from Daylight Donuts. In New Hartford, have you tried any of their lattes? They have over 14 different flavors. There's the pistachio, the Almond Joy latte. Or if you like it the way Manaski likes it, it's just plain black coffee.
Mm-hmm.
Seattle's best. Fresh donuts every day, fresh bagels every single day, and the drive through is very fast. You're in and you're out and you're on your way. Daylight Donuts in New Hartford. Speaking of New Hartford, this morning at 10 o'clock, they'll be leaving from the high school, heading to Glens Falls, where it's a it's the Final Four, Class A Final Four.
Yes, it's an exciting weekend, so we wish them the best of luck. And
we did
hopefully
not get
two games.
We did not get Heenan today. I feel like Heenan might be superstitious, and he talked to us last year at this time.
Yeah,
and they lost 2-0, so maybe he doesn't want to talk to us. Just out of superstition.
So he actually did reply to me. He said, "I don't want to talk to Bill this morning." So
I figured that was it.
They're going to
have an opportunity to redo last year. It's not often you get a redo, but this is absolutely that. So same team, same Saturday night scenario. The odd will be rocking, loaded with people, and they win here. They go to the Frozen Four. Last year they lost 2-0. This year it's going to be all about offense. And this has been a very offensive team. Think of the number of goals they've scored in the last month, in the last 30 days.
Yeah,
it's unbelievable. A lot of
routes. And were they number one in the country scoring?
I think they were. And they're number one. They're ranked number one in the country as well. So, in studio, Michael Harrison, comedian.
Hello.
And so on top of the podcast,
yep.
You have other stuff happening. It might even be a potential for a movie. What would the movie be about? What's that?
Movie? No, actually, we're being looked at for a TV show
for the podcast.
Yeah. We had to pitch it at Just for Laughs. It was great, man. Bob Odenkirk was there.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Amy Schumer. It was pretty sweet.
That's really cool.
Yeah, it was hilarious too because like it's so stressful. It was like what is it? They put us on a stage and then they put one of the heads of like BET, one of the heads of Paramount, one of the heads of Big Ten Production Company, one of the heads of Warner, and then we had to pitch to them, and then afterwards they did like a 10-minute Q&A on us in front of like a packed audience, and we're like,
that's awesome.
Yeah, we crushed it though, so I was pretty happy.
Yeah, I feel like that would be a really cool show.
So, did you hear, by the way, Amy Schumer's coming out with a new podcast called Character Impressions?
No way!
She is, yeah.
Jeez, I wonder where she got the idea.
Starts this weekend.
Genius.
Pretty sure, yeah.
She's a crook, allegedly.
She had a caveman on. I was like, oh,
how
no.
do you feel about that, where they say some people like to borrow material? There are certain comics that are big at stealing people's material.
That's awful, right? You're not supposed to do that.
Robin Williams, they said, was like one of the big ones.
He is. Yeah. Well, he was one of the big ones. I know, right? Yeah.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
I feel like he had a mind, though, that just everything stuck in it, and he would be stealing someone's joke. There's a story that I had heard, and actually it was a comic who played Fat Cats, who was back in the day on the lineup, and Robin Williams, when Robin Williams was younger, and he did that comic's act, stuff from his act, before he went up. So Robin Williams was up first, and the comic was like, yeah, thanks, you just did my act.
there's like a comic named Stephen Pearl. They say that Robin stole his personality. That's probably the biggest one.
Really?
Because Stephen Pearl did the same style and he didn't make it, right? So that was it. And so they were buddies. They both came out of San Fran. You know?
Oh,
so,
and they were buddies.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mind blown. Of all the rabbit holes I've fallen into that were pointless and useless, I'm not even aware that this one existed.
Yeah.
As an aside, just to sweeten it, though, Robin's also like the nicest human. I'll throw that out because I've met him. He was he was in Toronto shooting Man of the Year, and I was an up-and-comer, and he came in and did just a quick set at a place, destroyed it. But he stayed till the end of the night, and he was easy to approach. Everyone was walking up to him and telling him jokes and stuff.
Yeah.
And he gave him the time of day. And it was like, I will say that, it's super impressive human in terms of like being a nice dude and stuff.
Well, and
I mean, I know I don't like that doesn't make up for, yes, that.
The stealing.
Joke.
Well, but I wonder though if, I mean, have you ever been in that situation where you're saying something that someone else said? You're doing it subconsciously.
Yeah.
I mean, it's impossible not to have someone not have an impression on you in some way where you might lift something
well,
and not
I mean, it's
know
not
it.
Even like that anymore. It's like now we have like, you know, Twitter and everything. So everyone's writing jokes all the time and we're all shooting the same baskets.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We're all like making fun of like Biden or Trump or whatever. Yeah. So everyone's like looking at the spy balloon. Like after a day, we're starting to each other find the same correlations and same jokes and ideas.
Yeah.
So like,
that's why when comics draw, you draw off your own personality.
You have to.
That's what makes it unique.
100%. You have to talk about your own stories now, because like you cannot go general. You go general, then that's sort of where it gets easy.
People start doing
things other people have done. Because there's people who've done the same thing as other comics, and like, you know, they didn't see the other person before.
Right.
It's just obvious.
Yeah, it is. You're right. This stuff is obvious, and I guess you don't know where you're picking it up from sometimes.
Now,
so I wonder if some of Robin Williams, he just had a brain that remembered things and maybe did it subconsciously. I'm trying to give him the benefit of the doubt.
I mean, to be fair, comics told me he had a blank check on him all the time. So he was also good if a person is like, oh, you stole a bit, he'd pay them.
Wow.
So,
get out of here.
Yeah. There was stories of that. So he had that. With that said, I do remember the night I saw him. He had a really easy joke that I wouldn't even say stolen, but more stock.
Yeah.
But he talked about how like Evian spelled backwards was naive. What an old dumb like observation. But so many people have done that.
It's
like so easy, but you wouldn't blame them for it, because you'd be like, there's a million people who've seen that one. You know? I don't even think anyone could say that's their joke.
Right.
Yeah.
And the other part was his personality, where he was just all over the place. He was so, I mean, everything was moving so fast.
Right.
And he was great on, I mean, in the day, it was great on Carson. That was, you know, back then. You showed up on Carson, you got to sit on the couch.
Yeah.
You were legendary immediately. It's all of a sudden you were big.
You know he never did stand up on The Tonight Show?
Robin didn't.
No. He was like, all his buddies got on as a stand up. He didn't get it. So,
Yeah.
That was like one thing I remember, because I read a biography on him.
Yeah.
He was sort of upset about. But he never got to do stand up on late night.
Wow.
Yeah. But yeah, he was apparently a monster. Like, he would destroy a room like no one else. Plus, yep. super talented. Yeah. Impressions. Oh, I would book him on my show.
Yeah.
You know, like,
of course you would.
Of course.
And now you'll never be able to book Gallagher because Gallagher's gone.
Ah, I know.
Yeah, it's terrible.
All those watermelon lobbyists or so.
That's awful.
Finally.
He made a stop here for a night and 3 months.
You want to know a great story? This is hilarious, actually. I love this story. I had to work with Bobcat Goldthwait out in...
He's from Syracuse.
Is he?
Yeah.
Yeah, just down the road.
So funny. I knew he got big in Boston, so I always assumed he was from there.
Yeah.
But, I think we were working in, like, Fort Erie, Pennsylvania, and he was telling me how, like, they have a comedy condo where they put comics up.
Okay.
And apparently, a comic was telling him how he showed up, and in the living room was Gallagher. Gallagher didn't have a place to stay for like a couple of weeks, so he just stayed at this comedy condo after his weekend and then just lived there for like a month in Fort Erie, Pennsylvania. It's like, guys, like, I'm coming in to do a weekend at the club, and I guess my roommate's Gallagher.
Yeah,
who
knew? and he's just staying. Listen, you got to look up, if you search WIBX Gallagher Keeler Show, there's a story that I did up there about Gallagher who came here for a fundraiser.
Yeah.
And stayed for 3 months.
Wow. Lived with what? Listeners.
I spent Christmas night with Gallagher at my home. We had Christmas dinner. He told the dirtiest joke I've ever heard, and it included the C word, in front of my mother at the dinner table. It was that really quieted things down.
I mean, who says Christmas on Christmas Eve? But he said it.
Crazy. Oh, but God. He did not go away. He wanted to live with his fans.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, there came a point where I think the fans had enough and Gallagher had enough.
Yeah.
As well.
Wasn't there two of them? Didn't the brother?
The brother stole his act. He hated his brother. He wouldn't talk to his brother.
Talk about thieving.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, right. Great example.
There we go.
His brother would not only steal his act, but his brother would go around and just say he was Gallagher. You wouldn't know it was Gallagher's brother.
Exactly.
Completely stolen.
Oh, my goodness.
And he brought one change of clothes. It's all in the story. It's like it could be a short little tabletop book, our time with Gallagher.
This is great. Just after you're talking about it, I sort of like the second Gallagher better now.
That's right.
He just described to me.
Yeah, just hanging out with people. Hang on. Michael Harrison, Fat Cats Comedy Club this weekend. We're talking to the county executive. Coming up in a second, it's 8:35 at WIBX.
Hi, this is Shalene with Northland Trailers, located on River Road in Marcy. At Northland, we offer a full line of utility, snowmobile, enclosed, dump, and equipment trailers. We can also custom design a trailer to meet your specific needs. In addition to trailers, we have a full parts showroom, and we service what we sell. Our family business is proud to have been serving our community for over 4 decades. Northland Trailers is located right outside the city of Utica. So swing on down and let's talk towing.
Warner Sales and Service, building relationships, building trust.
This is Lynn from Warner Sales and Service. If you are push mowing your yard, using an inefficient lawn tractor, or your current zero turn spends more time in the shop than mowing your grass, it's time you look at a Hustler zero turn lawnmower. Residential mowers from Hustler are built like tanks and drive like sports cars. All Hustler mowers have fabricated welded steel decks. Don't settle on cheap units with flimsy stamped decks from big box stores. Come see us at Warner Sales and Service on the Greenway New London Road in Rome, just off Route 365 between Rome and Verona, and we'll guide you to the right mower for your property and your budget. Find us at warnerss.com.
Warners, where quality still counts at Warners.
Breaking news.
Tax refund shock is everywhere, but what is it?
My tax refund shrank.
Mine too.
The culprit? Pandemic-related stimulus payments and tax credits expiring. In this reporter's opinion, you need a tax expert.
Hey guys, Jackson Hewitt guarantees your biggest refund.
And tax prep is 50% off? Going there now.
50% off is a limited-time offer for new clients filing at participating locations. Max value $200. Visit jacksonhewitt.com/50 for terms.
You have cancer. Three words you wish you could unhear. But just because a cancer diagnosis may be a shock to your system doesn't mean cancer surgery has to be. Now, there's Edge Radio Surgery. It breaks down tumors in less than an hour per treatment. No knife, no hospital stay. Faster treatments, lower risk. Edge Radio Surgery, now at AMP of New York. Learn more at ampofny.com/edge. You may experience side effects which may be severe. Ask your doctor of Edge Radio Surgery. Associated Medical Professionals of New York is prepped for you.
Hey, you can listen to Jimmy Fallon this afternoon from noon till 3 on WIBX. And each day, Monday through Friday, noon till 3. He was at Fat Cats Comedy Club a couple weeks ago and spent some time with Bill and Robin Monjo from River Hills Properties. I'll get to that, but I'm going to tease you with this. Today, Jeff, this is a very big day. And Davey, a very big day. Today we will sign a deal to bring Jimmy back. And I'll tell you that he's not coming alone, and it'll be in a different venue. This is going to be pretty big.
Are you going to talk to him personally today?
I probably will.
I've only talked to him.
The things you want me to tell him? It is your birthday.
Yeah, tell him happy birthday.
Okay. Well, your happy birthday.
I would tell myself, but I don't want to be intruded.
We'll make that announcement with Jimmy next week. For now, this is Jimmy Fallon on River Hills Properties.
Hey, 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 it's your radio buddy Jimmy Fallon, and the last time I was up at WIBX with the Keeler Show, when I wasn't shutting down hecklers in the comedy club, I was learning all about Bill and Robin Monjo and their amazing philosophy of buying and selling homes at River Hills Properties. Folks, when you list your home with River Hills, you're getting an extra level of service it is not available with other agencies. And I, for one, can't imagine having people I don't know wandering through my home when I'm not there. It's bad enough I've got Lincoln throwing his keg parties when I'm on the road. But also, that's the way houses are sold up in Utica. But not with River Hills. Your River Hills listing agent is there every time your house is shown. They turn the lights on, they answer questions, and they make sure no one's going through your medicine cabinet. It happens. Trust me, I've done it to a few people. Not proud. But seriously, list your home with River Hills Properties and reduce your stress level. It's like having a personal assistant to oversee the sale of your home. So why wouldn't you list with River Hills? What the heck's wrong with you? If you're even thinking about selling your home, call my friends at River Hills Properties, serving Utica, Rome, the Valley, and the North Country. Call 315-896-1009. And remember, nobody sells homes like River Hills Properties. Tell them Jimmy Fallon told you to call.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
I kind of had a feeling, just a little bit of a feeling, that the county executive would be on today. I didn't know. I had no idea, but I had a feeling you'd be here. Were your ears ringing yesterday?
Well, I heard a little bit, and then people told me other pieces.
You now do, it seems like you do have an opponent. If he can get the signatures, is what he said.
You know, everybody's entitled and you know, has the opportunity, so we'll wait and see.
Although he did he get the conservative line?
No.
Okay.
Nobody really has gotten it, and nobody's even told us whether we have it. I mean, everybody says, you know, it's been like one of the great mysteries, I guess, in this political season. The whole conservative party has been kind of confusing for everybody.
Yeah, it's not being run really from out of
here
now.
So I mean, we screened, and I've yet to hear anything either way. But we're not circulating petitions, I can tell you that, for conservatives, because without their approval or endorsement, you really can't.
I think he said yesterday that he got the endorsement.
I thought he did, too, and it's interesting because you said you screened and then you never heard anything, and I want to say that's what Mike Galimi said, that he screened with the conservative parties and didn't find out that there was an endorsement until it was on our show.
Right, I know. It's bizarre. The whole thing is bizarre.
What is going on with, I mean, the conservative party had a problem in the fall.
Well, the local conservative party had gotten, I don't want to say disbanded, it had not failed to file.
Reorganize, the reorganizational.
Right.
And the state took over.
And state on the state end. So at that point, it goes to the state's conservative party to organize and to endorse, local, in this case, for Oneida County. And they've done some. They haven't done others. It's very confusing for all of us. I'm on the Republican line. I'm pleased for that. I've had that line every time, and that's my party, and that's what I'm grateful for the committee people and everybody that endorsed me over the years. The county chairman's a great partner and great friend, and we'll go from here.
All right. Let's talk about and the big issue yesterday. And I didn't want to be in a position where I'm arguing with Mike Hennessy, of course, is saying that he's out gathering signatures. If he can get enough signatures, he is going to run. But I feel like things are said that I have to contest. For instance, one of them being that Wolf Speed, and let's talk about that whole process where they open the new facility, or they've announced they're going to be building the new facility in North Carolina, which is where they're headquartered. But basically said that they're not telling the truth about the number of people who are working there currently.
Well, there are a couple things. It's always dangerous when somebody says things that they really don't know the background to, and that you don't get all of the story from.
Right.
You know, you don't get the whole, as the song goes, I think, you don't get the whole story from an article in the paper or whatever. I mean, you just don't. So let's back up. I mean, the North Carolina facility that they're building was a materials handling piece of Wolf Speed, which we did talk to them about, and we understood that they were building it close proximity to their main plant, which is in South Carolina, is what, you know, is essential, and it's easier, and it's just it's an economics decision in terms of transportation and material and all that. So while we made a pitch for it, we knew it wasn't going to happen here. But to the point of Wolf Speed right now, I mean, talking to them, I mean, and we're in constant communication with them. You know, and Greg Lowe just did a spot on Fox News a week or so ago about the hiring in the Mohawk Valley. And, I was at a meeting with one of the Wolf Speed people a couple of weeks ago when the chancellor was in town and talked about 325 people. I mean that's what I believe, and that's what there is.
And it's hard for us to say that if there, because that's what they told us on the air. It was close to 350. It was over 300.
Yeah,
people.
I think it was. But if
they tell you that's the case, it's very difficult to say to accept when Mike says, "Well, I know that they're not telling the truth. I counted the cars in the parking lot."
In all my years, when I wanted to find out from a CEO of a company, I go to the parking lot and count the cars. Instead of calling them up and say,
how many people do you have employed there?
I counted, by the way, here. You've only got 7, I think, here working today.
Well, we have decreased. We'll tell you that. There's no doubt in media. The media world is doesn't seem to be hiring the way we used to.
But it's not even worth the time of day.
Well, let me say this, though. There is something that's different than in years past, and I think there's some element of this even in this building where you have people who work for our team, but they work from home. And I guess that's been raised. I've received messages on that before. Do you know if that's true or to what extent where you have people who are like, assigned to the Mohawk Valley or the Marcy branch of Wolf Speed, but maybe they're in Connecticut, maybe they're in Pennsylvania, they're remote workers. Do you think there's a significant amount of that? Do you know about any of that?
I mean, initially there was when they were building up in Albany, you know, before the plant was ready and opened in Marcy. So they were doing some of that, you know, transfer work, if you will, and remote, but remote in Albany, not at their home. I mean, you can't build a chip in your home.
But you'll have people in the accounting industry.
I really go back to the point of what they've been hiring. I mean, they like people on site, and they've been doing that. Now, there are a lot of companies because of the pandemic that went to that, so you can go to certain, places and see that, you know, parking lots are half empty,
but people are
working home.
I spoke with a business person yesterday. They have a rather large workforce here in the area, and they said that I think the number was like 80% of their workforce is now working from home. But that's an industry, without getting into it, that's an industry that can do it. I know there's some industries
insurance, certain financial.
Okay, you didn't have to say that because I didn't want to say it was insurance.
I know, but there's a lot of insurance companies. There's many insurance companies here. There's direct carriers, and then there's...
And their parking lots are now empty today. Sure. Yeah. And I only threw that out not because I have any knowledge of people working remotely. Mm-hmm. It's just I'm trying to say that I'm not sure that counting cars in the parking lot is going to give you an accurate number of the people who work there.
Right.
When the company is telling us it's over 300, he's telling us it's not. I don't know where to go from there. Right.
Well, that's why I say it's not even worth it.
I live here. And, no, you don't live here. I live here. No, I don't. Right. These two issues we've had back to back.
I feel like that's the world we're in now. It's like someone with authority, someone in the position of in the know, can tell you something today. Someone who's spent 8 years in college and a field can tell you something today. And it's easy for someone like me that doesn't have that education to say, I don't believe it. That's where we are post-pandemic, that we don't trust people today, and we don't trust experts. Like, you know, there was a time when if an expert told you something, you're like, well, it must be true. Today, we don't believe it. Well, we trust Facebook.
Right. We don't believe it. Look, people don't believe me when I say certain things about, and he doesn't believe me when I say certain things about, you know, about whether it's about the budget or whether it's about, you know, the workforce or whether it's about, you know, other projects that we're working on. So, yeah, you can't change that, and, you know, you can't fix it, you know, in that regard. I mean, there's a saying that goes with that. Looking at, you know, to really focus on just wolf speed in terms of, you know, the industry and what we've been doing with it is kind of ridiculous as well with the investment that's been made, with the number of jobs that have ramped up a lot quicker than we thought.
Yeah.
Let's be real honest. The plant just opened up in April of 22. I mean, and so here we are. And there was never a promise for 1,000 jobs or whatever. You know, every time I hear, you know, whether it's him or other people talk, they add to it. You know, they add. I mean,
I believe it was always ramping up to 600. It was always the possibility.
And the possibility of more.
That it can grow.
Of more fabs, of more supply chain, of more things that, you know, could attach to it. So, It just, you know, it's unfortunate, especially when a company like Wolfspeed that really came here, you know, with obviously the state, you know, investment, but their investment and their workforce, you got to say, and I know you've had them and you've talked to them. I mean, they've been invested in the community. They, you know, they're really great citizens right now. And, you know, what kind of message are you sending them? I mean, this is a huge company. And what are you saying to other companies? You're going to go counter. Going to go in their parking lots, and
I just feel we got to get. We have to come to a point where, if you know, obviously, if you had a limit where there was an economic development deal that was done to bring a company in and they guaranteed so many jobs by such and such a date, there's got to be a checks and balance
and
system
there are,
in place,
you know,
for the county,
right? Well, on the county end, but we remember we don't have money directly into that project as far as the building and the jobs go. That's a state issue.
Mm-hmm.
And I worked for ESD, so I know how that works. And so there are milestones and benchmarks and things that have to be met in that regard. And it's based on the investment, the number of jobs, the time frame that the company, you know, outlines in terms of it, and what other circumstances, you know, might interfere with that. Because you saw during the pandemic, they threw everything off kilter, because if there were any job projections out there, they got thrown by the wayside because people stopped working or couldn't work or factories closed.
But I just think it comes to a certain point where if they say, we have this many people working here, I as someone, as a member of the media, there's not much else I can do. It's not like I can go in undercover and start counting people.
We should
people.
Set up a hot dog stand and see how many hot dogs we sell.
Or counting cars. I just don't think that's the answer.
You know, there is the ultimate checks.
I like the hot dog
stand. There is the ultimate
idea.
Checks and balances in terms of what they have to file with the Department of Labor and in terms
that's
of the,
it. That was state that's, money, so they're
But regardless, you do have to inform, you know, the Labor Department, the IRS, all those entities and business, you know, pieces that go in government, what your payroll is, what your numbers are. So ultimately, it is out there. It is there.
So I would ask you this, though. I feel he'd be better served to argue this point, and that is, keeping in mind that this money that came, this is really state money, which I know
it's
we can
all
have
our
that.
Money. It's
we
all
can
our
have
money.
That argument. It's all of our money.
It's all our
but
money.
I would rather the money come here that is being used for economic development in New York State, then go to Long Island. Okay, but with that said, the better argument is we invested that much money for that many jobs, even if it is 600, that means we basically paid $1 million a job or whatever. That's an argument that you can have. You the can. Problem, though, is that every municipality, every state, every county is out there fighting counties in other states around the country
for these jobs.
Yeah, and that becomes a rat race that you can't really ignore today.
Everybody says, and you've been dealing with this for a long time, and everybody says, don't incentivize. Well, you know, otherwise then you don't get anything. Then you don't.
Right.
You know, whether it's land, whether it's, you know, a break on the land, whether it's a pilot agreement on taxes, whether it's direct money to build the plant, whether it's money for workforce training, whether it's, you know, I mean, go on and on and on. You're in a competition, and either you want to be in that competition or not. Now, I mean, there are others that, you know, just build on their own and have that wherewithal, and that's great, and they can do that. But when you're dealing with major manufacturers and that competition is so great, especially in this industry.
Yeah.
But let's go back to, you know, I mean, let's go back to the pandemic. I mean, we couldn't get chips. We couldn't get things done. You know, here we are investing in something that
yeah.
is really, you know, great for our community in terms of the jobs, in terms of the workforce, in terms of what they're producing on a regular basis, and you're
there's a worldwide shortage.
Can I
just say, you know, there's an argument to be made, and I know that this is going to upset a lot of people, but for New York Democrats, including Andrew Cuomo, who invested all this money into this industry, look what's happened. Albany here, and then Syracuse. It's like at some point it felt like we were throwing bricks at the wall, hoping they would add up. And then it's like, boom, there was within 10 years we had these massive announcements about jobs and investment.
But it's because of a lot of there's the other side to the story. It's about what did you do to get them here? I mean, it's not just about throwing money at them. It's about investing in a community that you had stuff for them to do, that you had housing for them to go to, that you have infrastructure that they can rely on, that you have all these other pieces. I mean, that's what... You know, whether it's Mr. Hennessy or others, don't really get the big picture of what this job and what this whole, you know, aspect of governing is about. It's not just about, you know, one piece of paper and a budget. It's about a lot of different things that compile it. It's about public safety. It is about you know, public health. It is about all these pieces.
And I wasn't criticizing.
That makes a difference when you're attracting a company like Wolfspeed or anybody, or asking companies to stay here.
And I think we keep hearing rumors that we're close to another deal up there. But the reality, I think you have to look at things on a longer term basis. I mean, if you look at the last 10 years, remember, it was not that long ago. It might have been 8 or 10 years ago. The argument we were having is AMS. So it's never going to happen. And it didn't happen.
Well,
the point is that there's a company there now. It's a pretty well-established company.
Based on all that was said yesterday, I mean, it's real early to get into the political debates of an election because we're in it's March the 17th, and we've got a long way to go. But
2 weeks to go with signatures.
With
right?
signatures, yeah. Right? And then you know a primary if there is one, and then the general and all that. But you know, at the end of the day, it's like you know, I mean, look, I've done this before. Obviously, you know, I mean, I get called a career politician, but this is a guy who ran for 17 different offices. You know, and that doesn't count. But I guess at the end of the day, it's like, do you want Mike Hennessy, the guy to pitch your community, or are you happy with what we've been doing here?
And to be clear,
that's the question that people got to ask themselves, and you know, when they go to the vote, and that's what I have to put on the line every time I've you know put my name on the ballot, and I'll do that again.
And again, I shouldn't use the term throwing bricks at the wall or something, but like you couldn't have Marcy without. Infrastructure and everything that had to be to get that place ready for someone to come in. You know what I mean? It's just good to see that all that investment actually did pay off.
But you don't think the hospital makes a difference, the new hospital? You don't think that makes a difference in this? You don't think Nexus makes a difference in this?
Can I say again, pieces? what a difference 10 years makes.
Right.
Next weekend, if the Pioneers can win this game, and they damn well better win this game. They better blow these guys out.
See, I hope Heenan's listening.
I know he feels the same way as
he
I
does,
do.
He does.
We're going to win this game. And then next weekend, you're going to have the Frozen Four in Utica. Mm-hmm. The Comets will be home in Utica. Mm-hmm. The Nexus
has
a tournament with over 30 teams playing. Mm-hmm. That is all going on downtown while construction in the final months is going on next door at the hospital. If there's anything that you can point to, it's what's potentially going to happen next weekend. I mean, it's amazing.
Well, look, that's what we've been building upon, and that's why, you know, I chose to run again, you know, because of what we've accomplished. But there is still more to do, and there's still some finishing pieces, and you never stop. But, you know, that's why, I mean, and that's what, but there's so much more. I keep saying that. There's so much more to this job, to running this government, but to being involved with all of the pieces that, you know, we've been doing. And it's, you know, there's a lot of issues here. And it doesn't just center around counting cars in a parking lot. It's about, it's about, you know, being responsible, but also about, you know, building a community that people, you know, want to live in or want to visit or both. And I think we've done, you know, I'm really proud of the administration. I'm proud, you know, to serve. And I'm proud that, you know, we've, you know, put together a record and, you know, despite what, you know, my, I guess, I don't know if I call him an opponent yet, but.
We'll know in 2 weeks.
And we'll know in a couple weeks.
He's certainly committed. And,
it's still comical of, you know, the changing of the parties that, I mean, I still don't get that. I deal with that with the other, you know, the.
He said yesterday that his reason, though, is that the Democratic Party has left him. There have been a lot of changes in parties with a lot of different candidates.
But, you know, you've run for 30 years and one line.
So. You know, and I feel like that's a fair point. You can't call somebody else a career politician when you've run a number of times.
I worked in government my whole life. That's no secret. I've been called that before, and I'm proud of that. I mean, it's no different. Look, your wife's a teacher. I mean,
she's a career teacher.
I mean, what's wrong with that? That's great. I mean,
thank God she is.
Thank God.
I wouldn't want to have to rely on my pension here in radio.
For you, it's a
lifeline.
Thank God it is. I mean, there had to be some steady employment in that.
Holy crap! You can't count on me. I have someone asking, where did the? And you know what? I failed the last time you were on to ask this question, and he's asking again. He's curious as to where the money came from Nexus. How was Nexus built?
Nexus was built with obviously there were $22 million from state investment, which we haven't gotten yet, but I'm still waiting for it.
Yeah.
But how Nexus was built with bonding between the audit authority and the county standing behind them. The county, we are using a portion, when I raised the bed tax up to 5%, we are using a portion of their bed tax because it was allowed to be, I asked for it to be allowed to be used for capital expenditures. So a portion of the bed tax is going towards it, and Nexus itself, through the operation of Mohawk Valley Gardens and I want to say maybe a 60-40 split in terms of how we're paying that debt service over the next 30 years.
Okay.
That's how it's being built.
All right. You know, the question was in the very beginning, what is this thing going to accomplish? And we're seeing it every weekend.
Well, we're seeing it really every weekend. Incredible. And it's going to be growing. And you saw Rob, you know, looking at
building housing
over there. And we have some other pieces that we want to, you know, I've talked about time and again that we really need more for people to do over there when they come in, especially when you have a weekend. Like next weekend, do have the Frozen Four, if you do have, I mean, which you will, I mean, you have the.
Well, they're going to win. Comments, I tell you that.
You have the tournament. I mean, we need to build upon that, and and that goes back to the, you know, years ago when everybody said, "Oh, you can't do any of this stuff," you know. But here we are.
Pretty big. All right. Have a great weekend.
You too.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Even to the Italians.
At the parade tomorrow and. Camden.
Camden is the parade tomorrow. And today, where's today's, Davey?
Old Forge
has theirs today. So, all right, County Executive Anthony Picente, thank you.
Thank you.
WIBX Utica Rome, couple things. You still can get tickets at the box office for tomorrow night, Adirondack Bank Center. And this is a big one. Utica College in the quarterfinals as they're going dancing tomorrow night. New Hartford will be leaving at 10 a.m. this morning for the Final Four up in Glens Falls, Class A State Championship. Fat Cats Comedy Club this weekend. Michael Harrison, thank you for coming on this morning. You'll check him out. Hilarious guy. And check out his podcast, Character Debates, an awesome concept that we didn't get to do this morning, but really, really cool. And the Falcon Clinic. Did I get everything in?
I think so.
Yeah.
You want to mention the Falcon Clinic before we go?
I do. The Falcon Clinic in Washington Mills, accepting new patients. If you're looking for a new family doctor, call them today.
Hi, I'm Joe Carbone.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
315-50-JOE, you wait your turn. 315-507-4751 for the Falcon Clinic. If you're having pain, sleep issues, fatigue, ADHD, whatever your issue, you don't need a referral from your healthcare physician in order to go to the Falcon Clinic. Call today. Dr. Shemileski, Dr. Zielinski, 315-507-4751, 315-507-4751. The Falcon Clinic in Washington Mills.
Hi, I'm Joe Carbone. Welcome to Harley-Davidson of Utica. Get a jump on your riding season with over 120 Harley-Davidson motorcycles to choose from. Harley-Davidson Motor Company 120th anniversary celebration is March 25th. Stop in for food, beverages, music, and lots of Harley-Davidson giveaways. Register to win a 2023 breakout and a free trip to Milwaukee for the anniversary blowout. So come to Harley-Davidson of Utica March 25th for our great event.
Hello, Don Hartman from the Potting Shed Antiques. Nancy and I want to invite the community to shop the